starting to feel good about themselves again. And Austin with the Longhorns taking the field in front of this crowd, trying to build off of the momentum from that win against Oklahoma. But facing a Kansas State team today in Austin that has won 6 of the last 7 in this series. We say welcome inside. Joe Davis with Brady Quinn. Chris Button joins us in just a moment. So Texas in the second year under Charlie Strong had gotten off to that 1-4 start, Brady. They really needed that win they got in the Red River Shootout a couple of weeks ago, and they're hoping that they can build off of that moving forward.
Yeah, and the key word is confidence, Joe. When you've got such a young team like Texas playing this year, you got to build confidence. You have to build off that. And by the way, they played the toughest schedule in the country through the first 6 games. The schedule lightens up with the next 6 games in the Big 12 schedule.
Yeah, so bowl eligibility, obviously the goal, looking at what Charlie Strong and the Longhorns have moving forward. Kansas State, on the other hand, very proud program. Bill Snyder running the show. They've lost 3 in a row now, including that 55-0 loss against Oklahoma last week. It's a team, though, with a coach that has been in situations like this before.
Yeah, Joe, you go back to 2013. Kansas State started off 0-3 in the Big 12 then. They answered with 5 wins, only 1 loss, and then going to get a bowl win versus Michigan in the Buffalo Wild Wings Bowl. So look, familiar territory for head coach Bill Snyder.
All right, and his team again has won 6 of the last 7 in this series, including a shutout win over the Longhorns last year. It is Kansas State and Texas kickoff on the other side of this break.
The kick is on the way. It's plenty long, and it's good!
Over the middle! Wow! Touchdown! Oh, he missed it! Unbelievable!
And the kick is good!
And the Longhorns was an absolute gut punch heartbreaker. That's going to be it. Longhorn fans have been calling for a signature win. You have it!
Well, with the exception of that blowout loss against Oklahoma last week, these teams have played in a lot of close games. But at this point, trying to figure out who the real Kansas State is, who the real Texas is. You see the Kansas State play TCU close. They blew Texas out. And, of course, Kansas State, a team that lost to Oklahoma. Texas beat them 2 weeks ago. On this rainy day, let's go down to the field and Chris Button.
Joe, you think these two teams are unpredictable? How about Mother Nature? All through the night, including when we arrived at this stadium, it was pouring sheets of rain. Right now, it's slowed down a little bit, maybe about a steady drizzle. It's picked up here in the last few minutes. The wind also extremely strong down here. They expect 5 to 10 inches of rain down here in the Austin area. Talking to Charlie Strong yesterday, he says they were hoping the rain would come earlier in the week so that they would get to practice with the wet ball drill. Well, the rain didn't come till yesterday, but they did get to practice a little bit with the wet balls drill. The one other thing, they are expecting strong possibility of some thunderstorms, so we'll keep you updated on that.
Yeah, other than that, it's a great day for football. Charlie Strong signed that 5-year deal prior to last season. Bill Snyder, 76 years old, arrived at Kansas State in 1989. Texas won the toss, deferred to the second half, and Kansas State will start with a football at the 25-yard line. It is an offense looking for a bounce-back game. They were held to 110 yards and shut out for the first time since 96 last week against Oklahoma. It's an offense at this point searching. They ran for just 65 yards in that game. They passed for just 45.
And they've had a lot of pass attempts early in that game, and that's just not the identity of this Kansas State offense. They need to start running the football.
They start out of the gun. Huebner to run on first down, and Joe Huebner got decked after a gain of 4. And Huebner a bit slow to get up.
Well, if there's one thing this Texas team does well, and it looks like Joe Huebner's banged up, he's got to take a play off. The number 46, Malik Jefferson, number 19, Peter Jenkins, they come in and they actually fly to the football, some big hits. This time, it's safety, number 31, Jason Hall, laying a devastating blow on Joe Huebner to open the game. You're talking about a Kansas State team that lost their starting quarterback, Jesse Ertz, the first game of the season, first offensive play to injury. Enter Joe Huebner, who's been in and out due to, I guess, lack of performance, if you want to call it that. Cody Cook has substituted in, the wide receiver.
And Huebner also took the big shot against Oklahoma State a few weeks ago, had to leave the game for that. And the training staff out to look at him on the very first play. There is Cody Cook. And this will be, assuming that he does take over the quarterback spot here, his third appearance at quarterback this season.
And you go back to that Oklahoma State game in which Cody Cook came in for Joe Huebner. 10 of 16 for 122 yards passing, a couple touchdowns, and 87 rushing yards, one TD. So he's an extreme athlete and a guy who really originally came to Kansas State during his redshirt season as a quarterback and then transitioned to wide receiver.
How's this change?
Well, with the weather today, I think both teams are going to focus on running the football. It probably takes away a bit from the passing game, even though Joe Huebner hasn't been very efficient this year, but he's got a big arm to go to chuck it downfield and make plays in the passing game.
Well, Cook has been better as a passer has been in the quick game with the short throws. Could not have been a more nightmarish start for Kansas State losing Huebner. Second down and six. Cook swallowed in the backfield and dropped for a loss of three by Bryce Cottrell. And just like that, it's third down and nine for the Cats.
It looked like there was already a bit of a miscommunication between Cody Cook and Justin Sillman. That couldn't have been what they wanted to start off the game with. And center Dalton Reisner got beat off the ball right away.
As Texas defense, a unit gaining confidence. They had their best game against Oklahoma 2 weeks ago. Constantly brought pressure. On this third down, they bring only four. So Cook with time. Takes his eyes down and gets popped. That's a sack and a three and out. The true freshman, Malik Jefferson, the biggest recruit of the Charlie Strong era, was there on its fourth down.
And this sack was made possible because of the Texas secondary being able to coverage outside. Number 21, Duke Thomas, does a nice job locking down on Deontay Burton for Kansas State. That's where Cody Cook was looking. Once he didn't see any daylight, he tried to do his best he could to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Nick Walsh, third of the Big 12 in punting, off the side of his foot. Special teams normally a strength for Bill Snyder teams. It's not necessarily been the case this year. And a short punt gives Texas good field position. And as his offense takes the field, Brady, give us what we're watching for.
Well, you're going to see both quarterbacks today. Gerard Hurts, now the starter. Tyrone Swoops a year ago. But they've got a Swoops package that they like to call, well, 18-wheeler. Well, Peter Jenkins, the linebacker for Texas, likes to call it. He's credited with the nickname. And part of that rushing attack is going to include Jonathan Gray and Deontay Foreman, two different styles of running back. Foreman with a blazing speed once he gets in the open field. Jonathan Gray, more of a smash-mouth player.
Most run-heavy team in the Big 12. And Hurd running, that whistle, I believe, was marking the ball ready for play, and everybody thought that it was a whistle stopping play. Gerard Hurd was the only person that did anything.
Yeah, that's the type of reaction you'd like to see from your quarterback. Just keep playing. Obviously, everyone was a bit caught off guard, even the offensive line for Texas, but Hurd wisely got to the outside and got out of bounds for a nice gain.
Up seven, second down and three. Jonathan Gray with his first carry. And pushing forward, dragging that pile for a couple of yards. Marquell Bryant, credit for the stop in Texas. Looks at an early third down and one.
And already we see the 18-wheeler package. Passing game coordinator and wide receivers coach Jay Norvell calls it the wild package. They bring in Tyrone Swoops, who's every bit of 6'4", 245 pounds. And they just pound away with the football. They're bringing multiple tight ends. Caleb Blewett, fullback Alex De La Torre. These guys paved the way for Swoops.
It was the starter last year. Penetration shut the play down, but he bounced off a tackle and got close. Kendall Adams made the stop. This one will depend on the spot. Looks like you got a pretty favorable spot. And enough for a Texas first down.
Yeah, Adams was able to get back to the backfield and get a hit on Swoops, but he's got a 50-pound disadvantage with the size of Swoops.
Hurd back in the game. Redshirt freshman from Denton, Texas. Trying to get the corner. Britz did a good job of stringing the play out. And a short gain, it'll be second down. Last two games for Hurd, he's only thrown for a combined 100 yards, but he's running the football more than 100 yards in the win against Oklahoma 2 weeks ago.
He's rushing well, but over the course of the bye week, they really want to try to work on his footwork, his rhythm, and get back to what he felt most comfortable with, which is some of the passing game core concepts that you'll see throughout the game.
And we saw him against Cal have a pretty effective game through the air, not much other than that. Here's Jay Gray, Jonathan Gray for 6 yards to set up a third down and manageable. One of the more highly touted recruits several years ago. He's battled injuries throughout his career. Still more than 2,400 yards in his time at Texas. Third downs have been an issue for both of these units. Texas converted its first third down opportunity. And on third down and four, back to the ground. Gray plunging forward, and it looks like enough for a first down. So 2 for 2 on this opening drive for the Longhorns on third down.
And they're continuing the similar style of play as far as what they ran 2 weeks ago versus Oklahoma, having 58 rush attempts versus only 12 pass attempts. And obviously the weather is going to play a factor, being it's wet and rainy, a little bit of wind as well. But this Texas team's identity right now, offensively at least, is running the football and taking advantage of some play-action pass plays once they get things going.
You mentioned the 58 runs out of the 70 plays last week. It was their first 300-yard rushing game as a team since the opener in 2013. It's Gray again for a gain of 2 into the strength of this Kansas State defense, which is the interior.
It's the interior. It starts with the guys up front. Travis Britz, number 95. Will Geary, number 60. These guys are very stout, very quick off the football, have good pad level, and do a nice job of keeping linemen off the linebackers.
On second and 9, Hurd can't get around the corner. Will Davis up from his linebacker spot to drop him for no gain. Kansas State has put Texas into a third and long.
Third and long, and they're going to have to find a way to come up with some easy completions for Jerrod Hurd. As you look at the rushing comparison between this offense and this defense and the matchup today, something's got to give. But on this particular down and distance, this is where they really need Jerrod Hurd to come into play and be efficient in the passing game.
Only 100 yards passing over the last 2 weeks. He'll run it with a hole and a first down inside the 15. Kendall Adams with a tackle after a run of 16 yards.
Number 29, Sean Newland for Kansas State is going to flash on your screen. He had an opportunity, but Hurd just puts his foot in the ground and gets upfield. Again, Jay Novell talked about sometimes we use these quarterback draws and running plays essentially as passing plays for Hurd until he gains more confidence throwing the football.
And against the Big 12's top run defense, 10 plays, 10 runs, plenty of success. Gray again for 6 or 7. Elijah Lee with a tackle. It'll be second down. We've seen Deontay Foreman, the sophomore, start to get more and more carries and really flash some good things, but they're still going to ride Grace up.
Well, in particular when you've got a wet ball and bad weather.
Back to him here. First down and goal for Texas. Solely on the ground on this drive.
Played in 41 career games, and you're talking about Jonathan Gray, and who do you entrust the football with? Who do you entrust it not to slip out of their arm or their hands, especially as you get closer down the red zone?
Let the crowd tell you the package Texas goes to on first and goal. Swoops is back in. You said the 18-wheeler. How about Tyrannosaurus?
There's the Swoops Dozer. They've got all kinds of nicknames
for
this.
I don't like, because it worked at Oklahoma as Belldozer. Right, because it's supposed to bulldozer. Yeah. I mean, Swoops Dozer. In the world's that? It is Swoops, and it is a significant loss. Kansas State was ready for it. Arquell Bryant was there with Shermichael Moore at its second and goal.
Well, credit cornerback number 8, Duke Shelley, a true freshman coming off the edge. In for Denzel McDaniel, who's a senior at Kansas State. Shelley stepping up big time the past few weeks. credited with helping to stop Tyrone Swoops. It's no easy task. It takes a lot of times more than just one guy because of his size and athleticism.
See if they put the ball in the air for the first time.
Nope.
Short gain for Gray. Third down and goal.
I'll be curious to see if Texas decides to go into some of their empty packages. When they like to throw the football, they like to put Jerod Hurd back in shotgun by himself, spread the field, and try to utilize some of the one-on-one matchups, and it helps him see the coverage a little bit easier.
14th play of this drive. And Hurd looks to throw for the first time. Incomplete. Like some miscommunication. Johnson and Beck crossing in the end zone. The first throw is nowhere close to the mark. Fourth down.
Yeah, clearly a miscommunication between Hurd and it looks like Marcus Johnson. He's going to come up underneath of Beck as number 47 Beck runs to the corner of the end zone. Just like the ball was thrown a little bit behind. You don't know if it's wet. Maybe that played a factor in that throw being off the mark.
Well, regardless of what it was, you get a bit of a snapshot where they began that drive with 13 runs. Nick Rose, a soon senior out of Dallas in Highland Park High School, begins the scoring with a chip shot field goal. Texas runs its way down the field and stalls, settling for a field goal. Kansas State back to the field after this. FS1 College Football is presented by Geico. They don't care about the rain. There's something like 25 streets that have already closed in Austin because of the rain and the flooding. It was pouring rain all weekend.
They're not used to this type of moisture here in Austin.
Dominique Keith back to return this kick from Nick Rose. The rain is picked up again. Morgan Burns takes it across the 20. So Kansas State ready for its second possession. Joe Huebner was knocked out on that first drive, but it looks like he's coming back in as we give you what to watch for.
Yeah, and Joe Huebner's been effective in the running game, but he's got to hit the restart button passing the football. Last week versus Oklahoma, 4 for 14, 28% completion percentage. He was benched. So I think it'd be good for him just to clear his mind, start all over. And we saw Cody Cook already come in at quarterback. He's done that throughout the season. You'll see him at wide receiver and even playing quarterback, running the football at times in what they would like to consider their Wildcat package.
Again, they were held to 110 yards last week. First time they've been shut out close to two decades in that 55-0 loss to Oklahoma. Worst home loss of the Bill Snyder era. A game that they can't wait to put in the rearview mirror. Hoping for a bounce back performance in this one. The officials timeout. Looks like he's having issues with his headset.
Headset communication has quit working on the Kansas State sideline.
For once, the first guy to complain about his headset isn't me.
Well, that's an inside joke. I only wish people could understand.
I don't know that it's that inside. I'm just pretty picky.
Very picky.
Yeah.
Very high maintenance.
Oh, I don't know about that. Let's not push it. Well, get it figured out for Bill Snyder. It was the exception of that three-year hiatus from 06 to 08. Been at Kansas State since the late 80s. Second drive of the day for Kansas State begins at the 23. Flag down. That'll be a false start.
False start. Offense, number 65. 5 yard penalty. First down.
And normally, Kansas State very disciplined. Least penalized team in the Big 12. Always a staple of Bill Snyder's squads.
You know, and a key for any team when they're on the road is getting off to a fast start. Clearly, Kansas State has not done that yet. Really, when you look at Texas and Kansas State, both teams' records, when they get off to a fast start, they're pretty effective. So, unfortunately, Kansas State already playing in a hole.
And in a hole on this drive with a penalty on first down. The play clock winding down. and just barely got it off. Huebner taking a shot into double coverage. Incomplete. Hall was over there defending along with John Bonney as they looked for Kyle Kline, and it's second and long.
It was just a two-man route combination. He had number six, Deontay Burton, coming underneath, one-on-one open, and instead decided to throw to Kline downfield into double coverage.
It was actually Cook, Cody Cook. Beg your pardon.
Excuse me, Cook.
You just said what I said. I led you down a bad place there.
Well, either way, not a good decision you'd want to see at this part of the field, and Joe Huebner's really struggled in Kansas State territory, throwing the football in particular.
Second and 15. Back-to-back throws. And Huebner's first completion goes to Deontay Burton. Holton Hill, one of the true freshmen in that secondary, makes the stop, and it's third down and eight.
And if you wanted to build a prototypical type cornerback, it would be Holton Hill, 6'2", 280 pounds. He runs extremely well. And what I love about that last play was he was aggressive. He's been a little bit tentative this year, but that time he came up quickly to get the pass for the tackle.
Texas rushes only four. On the slant, slipped in beautifully, and Kyle Kline's got a first down, beating Duke Thomas. With a flag down, likely on the defense.
Pass interference, number 21 defense, a penalty to Kline, first down.
You can hear the wind howling on the microphone of Eddie Shelton.
And what a pass. I mean, this was right on the money for Joe Huebner. Had time, sat back. You can't throw that ball any better. Kyle Kline had no choice other than to catch that football. It was going to catch him.
So first down of the day for Kansas State. And Charles Jones slips through the middle with a first down to midfield. Their leading rusher a season ago has started to share the load with Justin Silman. His first carry of the day is a first down.
Yeah, and Charles Jones' best attribute is he keeps his legs driving through initial contact. You'll see some guys get a hand on him. He keeps driving, usually falls forward. Very productive with Jones and Silman in the backfield for Kansas State.
Jones again. Offensive line with a good surge. He gets six, and we go down to Chris Button.
Well, the Kansas State medical staff was looking at Huebner after that big hit. They were mainly looking at possibly an upper body injury, his shoulders, his arms and wrist area, but he showed no signs of pain, got up, was throwing the ball, told the staff he was fine.
All right, Chris. Injuries have been such a problem for this Kansas State team this year. They've had 20 players miss time, including 10 starters because of injury. Three straight carries for Jones. Made a man miss in the backfield and got close. Third down and one was tripped up by Malik Jefferson.
The man he made miss was linebacker Peter Jenkins. We had an opportunity to speak with him yesterday. And boy, can this guy talk. He basically kept the room laughing the entire time. Talked about how much he loves hamburgers. But really more than that, replacing linebacker Jordan Hicks and taking over that leadership and responsibility role for the Texas defense. Keep an eye on number 19 throughout the day.
K-State works out of the gun on third and short.
Oh, there's Peter Jenkins on the side of the screen.
It's Huebner. Penetration shut it down, and he lost a yard. Fourth down and two.
And credit the defensive line for Texas, in particular number 99 Desmond Jackson, number 95 Puna Ford. Watch the push. They're pushing the entire Kansas State offensive line into the backfield. Joe Huebner nowhere to go, and it really frees up Malik Jefferson, number 45 Anthony Wheeler at the linebacker position to be able to come up and make plays.
Second drive, second punt. First one went just 26 yards for Nick Walsh. He could have used this one on that first one. Should have traded his two punts. He's a 26-yarder there. Texas offense back to the field on the other side of the break. A 15-play scoring drive the last time, 14 of them on the ground. Rain continuing to fall. They've still turned out decently well here in Austin in a 3-0 game. Texas ready to take the field again on offense after a field goal on their first drive. 14 run plays out of the 15, led by Jerod Hurd, who's starting to give this program some confidence again.
Yeah, we talked about in the open the confidence of the whole team, and Charlie Strong, the head coach here at Texas, said Jerod Hurd's confidence is bigger than the stadium. He can't even hold it in. It's a pretty big stadium in here in Austin.
And Hurd had the gumption to fire back at him. How about your ego, coach? DeJay Johnson with the first down. He missed last game with a concussion. They're looking forward to his return. Gives him a big play threat.
Yeah, he adds a different element to this offense with his speed in the jet sweeps and really in the passing game as well, and as a returner. So he's a jack of all trades.
Deontay Foreman, the sophomore, has gone over 100 yards in back-to-back games. They'll continue to get him more and more involved in this offense.
Yeah, had a nice 80-yard run last week versus Oklahoma. They like his explosiveness and his ability to really get out in the open, get in the opening field. His twin brother, Armani Foreman, number three, playing wide receiver position. You'll see him on the field throughout the game today.
On second and six, Foreman again, drilled at the line of scrimmage. Finished forward for a yard. And it'll be third down. Travis Britz, Elijah Lee combining in the tackle.
Jade Norvell, the offensive play caller for Texas, likes to utilize this motion back and forth. It forces defenses to have to respect that guy. And it helps when you have a speedster like Johnson on the outside, who's effective with the run we saw on first down. And now you're starting to see empty sets. Where really it puts Kansas State in a bind on how they play Hurd.
On third down, Hurd steps up, takes off, first down to midfield. Well, he's talking with Coach Norvell and with Hurd himself. They've got the first couple reads. The third read is takeoff.
Yeah, he says it's 1-2 run. In this case, I don't even know if he gave the first read an opportunity, but the way they're blocking it, it looks more like a quarterback draw, and that's what you'd want to see. The deception to make it look like a pass, find an open running lane, and take advantage.
He's run for 39 in this first quarter. Foreman lowers the shoulder, the 240-pounder for six. Team plays for the Longhorns, 17 of them runs. Second and five, a flag down is Hurd, gets a first down, but a flag came out in the snap of the football. Sean Newland makes the tackle. And the call's gonna be offsides on Kansas State.
Offside, number 95 defense. Penalties declined. First down.
It's big Travis Britz. Yeah, I mean, and he's trying to find some sort of advantage, some way of stopping this Texas Longhorns running game right now. He's trying to take every advantage possible.
Here's Foreman with a gain of two. Will Davis makes the tackle. I'm talking about the big game Foreman had against Oklahoma. Second straight game over 100 yards. Said he played that game with a chip on his shoulder. Oklahoma recruited his twin brother Armonte steadily. They didn't offer Deontay. And in fact, through the entire recruiting process, it was Armonte that was drawing most of the significant attention. And Deontay has played with that chip over his first 2 years here at Texas. Maybe never more than against Oklahoma 2 weeks ago.
The awkwardness is with your offensive play caller and Jay Norvell. He was at Oklahoma. He was one of those teams
right.
That didn't recruit him. But when talking to Jay, he said, well, a lot of teams didn't recruit Deontay Foreman. So he says, we're just happy to have him. We're happy to see his development and really what he's turned into.
But all on the ground in this first quarter that comes to a close with Texas in front 3-0, trying to build off of the momentum of that Red River rivalry win. 3-0. On to the second in the rain. Speaking of Texas run game, Ricky Williams between quarters was honored by this crowd. He'll head into the College Football Hall of Fame this December. Heisman Trophy winner in the late 90s, one of the all-time greats.
One of a couple Heisman Trophy winners here at Texas, Earl Campbell, the other. You know, 1999, he was the fifth overall pick.
Jay Johnson got the corner and then slipped. Got a first down, though.
Going back to Ricky Williams, you know, in 1999, he was the fifth overall pick to the New Orleans Saints. Head coach Mike Dickett traded all his picks in that draft just to get him. That shows you the value of what Ricky Williams really provided a team.
You think he likes this attack so far today?
I bet he wishes he could suit up and be in this backfield right now.
19 runs for 76 yards. There's another run with a flag down. Bouncing off the tacklers is Foreman down to the 12, but a flag back in that mess around the line of scrimmage.
Holding, number 95 defense. Penalty declined. First down.
And really, if not for linebacker number 9, Elijah Lee, Deontay Foreman's taking this one to the house. Talk about how hard he is to bring down because of his size, weighing 240 pounds, but he also gets low his pad level, not much to tackle.
Foreman again. Elijah Lee helped finish him off after Britt grabbed the hold of him. And it's second down. They can get a first down here if they could get to the 2. Not scoring.
I'm just waiting for that 18-wheeler package to come back in. I love watching that smash-mouth football. It's seldom seen anymore with all these spread offenses in college football. So I love seeing the big boys up front just move off these defensive lines.
I love the spark that it seems to give Texas. Here comes Johnson. He was just window dressing. Instead, Hurd yanked down by Tanner Wood, 6'5", 265-pound sophomore. Brought Hurd down, and it's 3rd and 8.
And we talked about these spread offenses. It almost looks like you're trying to defend the wishbone just from shotgun with all the different options you have. It's kind of that dive read with Deontay Foreman or Jonathan Gray. The quarterback's keeping, and he decides whether or not to pitch to a guy coming across in motion like Dajay Johnson.
Well, Texas, the worst third down team in the Big 12 on the season, but 4 for 5 so far today. On third down, Hurd under pressure, felt it and got away. Hurd towards the end zone, it's first down and goal. It broke down, he beat the rush, ran for 8 yards to extend the drive.
Well, he's a problem fixer. Clearly, they're going to be one short. You see Jordan Willis coming off the edge. And Jerod Hurd just makes a man miss, fixes the issue. And gets Texas a first and goal.
And gets you your wish.
There it is, the 18-wheeler. You know what they're about to do.
Swoop straight ahead into the end zone. Touchdown, Texas. A 15-play drive.
You're going to see number 52, Shermichael Moore. He had an opportunity, but swoops with a head of steam. It's too tough to bring down. And it's seldom you see these blocking schemes anymore in college football. It's tough to defend against.
Nick Rose, after the high snap, was pulled down nicely by Trey Holtz, the holder. Knocks it through, and Texas in front 10-0. Bit of a tough road for Swoops, who was the starter last year. Started the opener against Notre Dame, struggled, lost his job, but he's got some of his swagger back, I think it's safe to say. Big part of this Texas attack now. First touchdown of the day for the Longhorns. FS1 College Football is presented by GEICO. Back in Austin, back in the rain. Some parts of this state, they're calling for 15 inches of rain over the weekend here with Hurricane Patricia in the Gulf of Mexico right now. 130 mile per hour winds as part of that storm. Just getting the edges of it here in Austin. How about the attack from Texas so far? 15 yards or 15 plays in a field goal, 13 plays in a touchdown.
And look at that time of possession. And that's really what makes it difficult for any offense to get into a rhythm like Kansas State is trying to today. Adverse conditions. Quarterback Joe Huebner already knocked out for a little bit, came back in. Tough to get into the rhythm when that's the case and all the things going on around you.
Morgan Burns took the opening kickoff of the season back 100 yards for a score and has room down the sideline to give Kansas State good field position across the 35. They'll start at the 36 on the other side of this break. I believe we're on to the second half of the college football season today. For our Nissan Heisman Watch.
Guys on this list, a lot of running backs, Fournette, Boykin, well known, but Henry's really stepped up the play for Alabama. Big game last week versus Texas A&M. Dalvin Cook has been sensational, just every bit as good as Leonard Fournette, carrying Florida State to an undefeated record. Seth Russell struggled a little bit today so far versus Iowa State, 5 for 15, but he does have a touchdown and actually has rushed for another. Paxton Lynch, the guy's not on this, but he's on the radar now. 7-0 is Memphis. Big win last night versus Tulsa. 3 touchdown passes, 1 rushing. A lot of guys still in the mix.
Kansas State trying to get some rhythm going offensively. They've been shut out 6 consecutive quarters now. When you go back to the fourth of that TCU game. This drive begins with a Huebner run. Off of the read play. Slips outside. Gets popped by Haynes up from his safety spot after 7. Scoring first, such a big part of the equation for both of these sides, and especially today when you consider the contest.
Well, yeah, and really what it means is it talks about momentum. You know, when you're a college football player, you feed off of that a lot of times, feeling that energy, feeling that momentum, and it helps whenever you can get off to a fast start, really for any team.
We talked about Texas trying to build off of their momentum, Kansas State trying to establish some new momentum after that embarrassing defeat last week. On second and short, it's Jones for a first down, but flags flying all over the place.
Holding, number 56, offense, 10-yard penalty. Second down.
Just about everything going wrong for Kansas State so far, even on the sidelines on that previous kickoff. Morgan Burns, who has a good return. Watch who he finds.
All right, that's Bill Snyder right there, the head coach. 76 years old. I mean, you'd never want to see anyone take that shot, but he's okay. He's tough. He's been through those before, I'm sure. His long tenured career.
Kansas State hadn't won a game in 3 years when he took over in 89. He's turned them into one of the most consistent programs in college football. Second down and 13 after the hold. Play clock winding down. Huebner with time to throw. Floats up there and Burton went up and got it. You see some of the effect of that rain as it popped out of his hand. Burton pulled it in, third and short.
And Deontay Burton's the leading wide receiver for Kansas State. He's the guy who's got to step up. Fill the big shoes left behind from wide receiver and kick returner Tyler Lockett from a year ago. He's having a sensational year up at the Seattle Seahawks, but Burton's looking to try to fill those shoes and be that guy.
Under pressure, Huebner throws too high, fourth down. Over the head of Dominique Heath. Is defended by Jenkins, and the punt team comes out for the Wildcats.
Peter Jenkins stepping into that leadership role. We talked about how vocal he was. He's the guy who helps get this defense aligned and really making plays. He was making it rain right there, which I don't think he needs much help.
I was gonna say, no. Third punt of the day for Nick Walsh. His best one of the day. Johnson has it go over his head and bounces into the end zone. 57-yard punt. Longhorns off to a 10-0 lead. Continuing that momentum. FS1 College Football is presented by Geico.
At Ferguson, nobody.
So much history in this program. Four national titles, couple of Heisman Trophy winners. Charlie Strong trying to get him back to the upper echelon of college football.
Well, you can really tell how much these players love Coach Strong. Carried him off the field versus the Oklahoma win.
Comes to Jay Johnson, second drive in a row. They've started like this. Second drive in a row. They've gotten a first down off that play. 13-yard gain for Johnson.
And that's a pass completion. A lot of people think sometimes that's a handoff. It's not. Whenever the quarterback receives the ball in shotgun and tosses it forward, that's considered a pass. That's a completion. That's going to help the quarterback rating for Jerod Hurd.
Hurd's so efficient, right? 3 for 4.
Yeah,
two of those three.
That helps.
Are those option or those sweet plays? Jonathan Gray with a gaping hole and the first down. And tripped up by Kendall Adams after 13 more.
Look at the hole created by the Texas offensive line. In particular, their center, Taylor Doyle, number 74. See number 77, Patrick Vahe.
Good penetration this time as Texas hurried to the ball.
Yeah, they're trying to pick up their tempo a bit. I think they feel the momentum. And when you have these soggy, wet games, you want to keep your energy up, keep the tempo up. If things are working, keep putting pressure on the defense to try to stop what they're seeing out there. Dajay Johnson in the backfield. Different look for Texas.
Motion him out. Looking that way. Now Hurd spinning his way free. And drop for a loss by Travis Britz. Two-time honorable mention all Big 12, but that play was going nowhere from the start.
Well, I thought Hurd actually should have taken a shot outside to Dajay Johnson. It looked like he wanted to go there. He was hesitant for whatever reason. They had good blocking on the outside to really set up the wide receiver bubble screen. But Hurd thought otherwise, and I guess that's the safe play if you're not quite sure.
Third down and long. Texas has dominated this down so far today. Hurd has the edge sealed. And fights his way for a Texas first down. Deflating for Kansas State. Sean Newland with a tackle after 13 yards.
And look at the blocking scheme. Watch number 36, Alex De La Torre. He was able to get a guy out on the edge to spring Jerod Hurd. And they really look at that as a passing play. Anytime Hurd has the football and gets outside on the edge, Jay Norville talks about that all the time.
Gray goes for 4 or 5 on first down. How about this offensive line, Brady, that continues to develop? It was a revolving door last year, starting to get some continuity.
Yeah, they had 7 different offensive linemen start this season, and finally over the bye week, they were able to get some guys healthy. Connor Williams banged up, Patrick Vahe banged up, Kent Perkins finally back at right tackle.
Hurd off the left side, got around the edge, hit the seam and got a first down. Kendall Adams pushed him out. There's a flag down in the backfield.
It's going to be holding on Connor Williams, number 55.
Holding. 55 offense. 10-yard penalty. We play second down.
Just when we start to praise the O-line.
I didn't like this call, but here's Connor Williams at left tackle, and you're going to see him try to do what's called a reach block. So he's got to get his hips out in front of number 45, Marquell Bryant, and it seems like he's engaged and he's running that way. I understand the ball carry is going that way, and maybe he's tugging on, not letting him go. But what else do you expect him to do? Yeah. Marquell Bryant was lined up outside of him. That's just a tough job for any left tackle that's trying to get outside of their defender.
He's one of the two true freshmen that they've added to the three returning starters up front. Athletic kid, Williams is. Jim Harbaugh offered him as a tight end at Michigan. Johnson coming in motion. He'll take the fake. Gray takes the ball and explodes. Jonathan Gray is inside the 10. Pushed out of bounds. First and goal, Texas, after a run of 46.
Look at the clean path that Jonathan Gray is able to run through. And it's not only the offensive line, it's the blocking downfield by the wide receivers as well. That's what helps spring those big runs, is the blocking downfield by the wide receivers playing unselfish.
They bring swoops in. The goal line situation. And Newland came off of the edge and shut it down. There is another flag.
Newland may have got the jump on that snap.
Offside, number 75, defense. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
Excuse me, that's number 75, Jordan Willis. It's no secret. Whenever Tyron Swoops comes in the game, they know they're going to run the football. However, Swoops did have a passing touchdown last week in this formation, and I wouldn't be surprised if they didn't dial that up right now with Swoops still in the game.
They've run it 30 of the 34 plays so far. Late substitution for Kansas State. Swoops counter play, his second touchdown of the day.
Joe, you called it. The wrinkle to this package wasn't the power play, it was the counter. And Swoops is going to come right back the other side after taking a jab step. Alex De La Torre helped leading the way, as well as Andrew Beck, number 47. Pretty much a clear path. Got to credit this Texas offensive line.
Somewhere through those raindrops is a high snap and a kicker getting belted. Trey Holtz couldn't pull down the snap from Kyle Ashby, and the Nick Rose paid the price. 18-wheeler, Tyrannosaurus, whatever you want to call it.
It works.
Yeah, that's the point. That's the bottom line. So is 17-0 Texas. Huddle up with college football experts and live web chats all season long. There's a new guest every week. The Edward Jones College Football Huddle on FoxSports.com. Joe Davis, Brady Quinn, Chris Budden back in Austin. Swoops of the second rushing touchdown. And another long sustained drive for the Horns. Morgan Burns back to receive this kick from Nick Rose. Short one, danger, Texas football. Kevin Vaccaro, who forced a fumble in the Red River rivalry on the kickoff team. He recovers this one that was dropped in beautifully.
Notice the trajectory on the football with enough air to allow the special teams players for Texas to go down and recover the football. That's what you look for on any of these kickoffs, are soft spots that allow you to run down and get the and recover the football.
Nothing soft about Texas today. Hold them. They love them some Ja Rule.
Well, clearly they're prepared for some sort of flood or monsoon, but look at this guy. He's got quite the chew in. That's just unbelievable.
Leave that one alone. Here's a little more family friendly fun. How about Vaccaro recovering that special teams play, and Texas back at it with Deontay Foreman running inside the 25. Our first down gain of three.
Kevin's brother Kenny Vaccaro, great Texas Longhorn safety here, drafted to the New Orleans Saints, following his brother's footsteps.
Texas over the last six quarters, 90 runs, 16 passes, and a good number of those passes are jet sweeps that, you know, essentially are runs. They lose a couple of yards here as Foreman slips down, and it's third down in 8 or 9.
Texas would like this not to be their identity. They'd like to have a bit more balance. I think every offense would like to be that case, but at this point, though, you want to win when you can, and then this is their identity. This is how they know how to win best.
Texas 6 of 7 on third down today. Finally, Kansas State able to come up with a stop. And time now for a Lowe's game break. We say hello to Jenny Taft.
Joe, thanks. Well, second-ranked and undefeated Baylor hosting Iowa State in another rainy matchup. Shock Linwood find some room for the 17-yard touchdown run, and the Bears are rolling in this one 28-0 in the second quarter, not letting the weather conditions be an issue. Joe Brady.
No, what is new for Baylor? Fourth down and Texas looking to go for it. Hurd takes his eyes down and slides down, avoiding the hit, but also coming up well short of the first down and maybe what Kansas State needed to get some momentum back.
We're going back, looking at the last play. This is just a quarterback draw. You've got four wide receivers at the top of your screen. They're trying to help clear out any Kansas State defenders in the box. But Kansas State has seen this before. Wise play by the KSU defense. We'll see if they can change the momentum when they come back.
Hey, Doug, got that
farm halftime. Rough weather all over the state of Texas. Would it dampen number two Baylor's offense? Plus, some pregame jawing before Clemson and Miami. And we'll check in on number 25 Pitt, who's ranked for the first time since Dave Wannstedt was the coach. Joe Brady, we'll see you at the break.
All right, guys, looking forward to it. Charlie Strong elects to go for it on fourth down instead of attempt the field goal.
Yeah, we just saw the botched PAT snap. They've had some special teams issues before, but you wonder if that'll come back to get you at some point in this game if K-State can rally.
But at this point, only 57 yards of offense for the Wildcats. 1 week after they had just 110 total. Texas brings pressure against the run, and it leaves Huebner with room for a first down up to the 40. Longest play of the day for Kansas State is an 18-yard Joe Huebner run.
Well, defensive coordinator Vance Bedford's putting a lot of bodies up around the line of scrimmage. Look at that. Well, the tough thing is no one's responsible for Joe Huebner, the quarterback. That's why you see such a clear running lane, and then it's left to Dylan Haynes to be able to make an open field tackle.
Which he didn't do, as Bryce Cottrell came back from his defensive end spot to get it done. From the 40, they fake to Jones. Huebner steps into a back shoulder throw for Gronkowski, the youngest of the Gronkowski bros.
Somewhere the Gronkowski family is going to a keg stand for that play. Watch as Glenn Gronkowski releases down the field off the play action fake. They get cornerback Holton Hill to bite up on the run. It's a 2-on-1 on safety Jason Hall. And Glenn Gronkowski with the nice hands. Great genetics that family has.
Let's pace ourselves, though, with the party. And it's on to the second quarter. Jones tackled by Hall. 3 or 4 yards. And it is second down. Glenn Gronkowski is a junior out of Amherst, New York. Twice he's been all Big 12. And he's got NFL potential at the fullback spot.
And here's the family. Look at these guys. They like to have a good time. Just genetic freaks when you look at them. I mean, these guys are athletic, they're big, they're fast. They're born to play the game of football. And Glenn just falls right in their footsteps.
Glenn goes out on second down and 6. They bring Cook in motion and flip it outside to Charles Jones. Angled out by Peter Jenkins. 2 yards short. Third down coming up for Kansas State, putting together its best drive.
I love the design of this play. They use number 19 Cody Cook in motion to throw off Holton Hill. He's really the only backside defender. And there Charles Jones receives the pitch, and he's all by himself to get a nice little gain. Fantastic design.
Wildcats just 1 for 4 on third down so far. Huebner behind Gronkowski. Got decked by Hall. Right at that yellow line, which is unofficial. And they will spot him really close. This might call for a measurement.
Very conservative team. Kansas State rarely goes for it on fourth down. They're 1 for 1 on the season, so. If they do choose to go that way, this is not a first down, but I think he might have gotten enough.
That one attempt for Bill Snyder's team, that's the fewest in FBS.
Credit Joe Huebner's patience if indeed they do get the first down here, because it didn't look like there was much running room. But Huebner waited, and he found a seam, and he took it to be able to get upfield.
Length of a football. I would assume that this will be the second fourth down attempt of the season for K-State, and it will, as Huebner comes back out with a play call.
Imagine their style of play. They'll be This will be a power running play as they bring in multiple fullbacks. Winston Dimmel, number 38, number 48, Glenn Gronkowski. Talked about him before, and these guys were built to be people movers.
Yeah, Texas, meanwhile, one of two teams in the country that has not stopped a fourth down. Opponents 4 for 4 on fourth against the Longhorns. And K-State with just one attempt. So they're going to review the spot.
And I've loved the play calling by Kansas State. They've been great so far in this drive, mixing some things up, showing Texas some different looks. As we take a look at this last play, the Lions are unofficial, so don't let those deceive you. However, they do give us some sort of indication of where the ball should possibly be spotted and where the first down marker would be.
I think in this case, the yellow line is in a really perfect spot. So pretty good guideline here.
This might be the best view. His knees down right there. And they'll have to try to determine where exactly the ball is at. It's on the 34 or just short of it.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Fourth down.
All right, so it's fourth down and less than a foot for Bill Snyder. And it looks like they will go for it. Big play late in this first half.
And you had mentioned Texas hasn't stopped anyone on fourth down yet this season, so Bill Snyder should like his odds on this particular play.
Strength of that Texas defense, the interior. Fourth down and a foot, and Huebner sneaks it for a first down. So Texas still has not stopped a fourth down this year, and inside of 3 minutes, the drive continues.
What makes this play so effective is a rule change. You're now allowed to push the ball carrier. So watch everyone behind Joe Huebner help push him forward to basically get the momentum to get the first down. That's a rule change. It was different back when I played. That was actually an illegal play, not always called.
No.
But in this case, now Kansas State uses it to their advantage.
As Reggie Bush and Matt Leinart reminded you of. Just can't pull the ball carry. First down and 10, 32-yard line for Kansas State. Jason Hall aggressive from his free safety position, and Charles Jones gets only two.
Number 31, Jason Hall came out from the defensive secondary up to make the stop. At some point, Kansas State's going to have to challenge the Texas secondary downfield. And in plus territory, that's a good thing for Joe Huebner. He's actually been pretty effective passing when he's in the opponent's territory versus his own territory.
Flag comes in. Texas players clapping.
Illegal substitution. Offense. Breaking the huddle with more than 11. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Turn it off. Oh. Not a good sound, that microphone. And not like Bill Snyder team. Had a couple of penalties. They've been picking up momentum. That's the fourth of this first half on the Wildcats. Clock winding inside of 2 minutes in this first half. Second down and 13. Huebner on the slant behind Burton, who pulled it in and got 11 to set up a manageable third down and short, beating Duke Thomas in coverage.
Well, that's the matchup they'd like to utilize. Deontay Burton on, it looks like Duke Thomas in this particular case. Burton, a nice move off the line, good suddenness, and really being able to catch a ball that was thrown a little bit behind him, allowing Kansas State to be in third and manageable. You can expect Texas to bring at least 4, 5, maybe 6 defenders. They've been heating it up a little bit as Kansas State's gotten into the Texas territory.
8 men in the box for Texas, taking their chances on the outside. Timeout. You can see that rain continuing to fall. coming up next. Our full day of college football across the Fox networks continues. Kansas and unbeaten Oklahoma State. And then on Big Ten Network, it's Wisconsin and Illinois. On Fox tonight, third-ranked Utah goes into the Coliseum to take on USC. How about Utah being the final unbeaten team in the Pac-12?
How about Utah being the underdog in that matchup, playing in the Coliseum? We saw USC get beat by Washington at home. Suffered another loss to Notre Dame last week, which you better believe I was happy about.
Yeah.
So interesting to think that a USC team suffering two losses, head coach has been fired, all the drama going on, yet they're still favored versus Utah. A bit surprising.
That's later tonight in just a minute. It's a State Farm halftime. 57 seconds remaining in this first half. Kansas State desperately needs to cash in on this opportunity. Jones fighting forward, pushing that pile, and it'll be close. Taking advantage of the rule you mentioned. Can't pull, you can push, it will be very close.
Well, they go with the zone read play. Texas stays at home for Joe Huebner, so he hands it off. And now you're watching the Kansas State offensive line get some push. I think number 55, Cody Whitehair in there, their left tackle. Talked about Charles Jones and his ability to keep his legs driving even after first contact. So it makes him very effective as a runner, very productive, and helped in that case.
Once again, we're going to have a measurement. Two timeouts left for K-State. Down 16-0. This time around, they've got it. How about the fight from Jones and from that offensive line, boosting him forward?
Well, huge, but look, we've got 42 seconds left in this half. Kansas State with two timeouts. They've got to be a little bit cognizant of their play selection here before they run out of too much time. You'd like to be able to come away with a touchdown, although a field goal will help, but it's only a two-score game at this point. All is not lost, and I think Bill Schneider knows that if he can get a score here, get into halftime, calm his team down, they're going to have a shot in the second half.
Texas will have the ball to begin the second half. Charlie Strong looks on, pleased with the way his team has played so far today. You've got to figure, running the ball with authority and pitching a shutout. Almost for a full half. Kansas State threatening. Deepest they've driven today. They already have more yards than they had last week in the 55-0 loss.
Please reset the game clock to 45 seconds.
So they added 3 seconds. It was at 42. They went to 45 because of the first down. The clock should then stop once they snap it back into play after the measurement. That's what's being sorted out right here.
They roll Huebner, looking back. Throwing end zoned. Flag flies out. Burton was pulled down to the ground. They're going to call pass interference. It looks like on Holton Hill. And that's what the call is, making it another first down, moving the ball even closer.
Well, Kansas State is going to utilize a boot pass, but watch Deontay Burton as he runs what's called a V route. Excuse me.
You get it.
Huebner rolls to the right. The entire Texas defense runs with him. You can see the contact by Holton Hill to prevent Deontay Burton from getting to the end zone.
Love your little blue locator, though. Sweet. First down and goal now for Kansas State. They bring pressure. Huebner sets. Throwing to a wide open man. Dominique Heath. Touchdown. The redshirt freshman with his second score of the season. And it gives K-State reason to believe with 32 seconds in this first half.
That's how you answer and watch Dominique Heath. He's just going to run up the field and get a quasi pick from Cody Cook. Dylan Haynes has struggled in pass protection this year for Texas. Meanwhile, Dominique Heath, the redshirt freshman, coming up big, really playing a big role in this passing offense. Second wide receiver. Now they're going for two.
Trying to make it a one score game. Timeout Texas. You okay with chasing points this early?
It's a bit early, but look, if you feel like you've got momentum on this drive, I'm not going to try to make that decision over a coach like Bill Snyder. Yeah. Clearly he has the pulse of his team. He understands what he needs to do here on the road versus Texas. And as much as they've struggled, I guess, in the past couple weeks offensively, you'd think that he would like to try to take advantage and seize the momentum while they have it. Fox Sports Supports is proud to team with Boys and Girls Clubs of America, supporting their mission and helping young people to reach their full potential through programs that promote character, leadership, education, healthy lifestyles, and more. For more information, visit foxsportssupports.com.
Dude, you're getting so good at that.
It's about reading. That's what it's about. If you can read, you can do that.
So Kansas State ready to go for two. Trying to get this to a one-score game.
I'm curious to see if offensive coordinator Dana Dimmel will utilize Joe Huebner's running ability and have some sort of boot action where there's a run option for Huebner and a passing option, putting Texas in a bind. And we saw in the last play, defensive coordinator Vance Bedford turned up the heat, brought a blitz. Huebner read it, found his matchup with Heath on the outside, and capitalized.
See the difference in those first three drives versus what they did on this 10 plays, 78-yard scoring drive. Joe Huebner leading him down the field. Wasn't the prettiest spiral that he threw on the touchdown, but the man was wide open and it got there, giving Kansas State its first point since the third quarter of the TCU game.
It'd be a bit hard on the guy. It's almost a torrential downpour out there, and you want perfect spirals.
I didn't want it. Just pointing out that it wasn't quite one. Doesn't matter, though.
One-on-one coverage on the outside.
He'll throw. Double clutches. Heaving one out of the back of the end zone. And on the two-point conversion, he'd love to see him at least give a player a shot. And an interception, not an issue on a play like that. Pressure came from Shiro Davis to force the errant throw. Heath with a score. Kansas State is on the board. It's 16-6. Final seconds of the first half.
Great rates for great rides.
Rain still coming down pretty hard at this point. It's been harder and then lighter as the day's gone on, but I'm not sure there's been any moment where it's not been at least sprinkling. Jay Johnson back to return this kick from Jack Cantelli. Try to keep it away from Johnson. Chris Boyd drops it, picks it up, then goes down. Good special teams work this time from Kansas State. It is Jade Kirby with the stop. World Series begins Tuesday. Daniel Murphy in those six straight games of the home run, leading the Mets in to take on the Royals, their second consecutive Fall Classic. Coverage begins at 7:30 Eastern on Fox Special extended pregame coverage starts at 7 Eastern on FS1. Who you got, Brady? Mets, Royals.
I'm just curious to see if Daniel Murphy's going to cool off. I mean, he's been absolutely sensational so far at the plate for the Mets. You got to think eventually he'll come down to this cloud nine performance.
Yeah.
I mean, law of averages usually evens out at some point.
Babe Murphy, 27 ticks. No reason to believe they'd do anything other than what they've done this entire half, and that is run the football.
And they get the ball out of halftime as well, so that's going to play a factor. No reason to take a chance.
36 of their 40 first half plays were runs, and two of the four, quote, passes were sweep plays that just technically are throws. Right now, we send it to Rob Stone in Los Angeles.
All right, Joe, thank you. Running the ball, kind of the story today in this one, just 13 first half pass attempts. We welcome you to the State Farm FS1 College Football Halftime Show. Rob, Matt, Dave, back here with you. 2 weeks ago was Texas shocking Oklahoma. They had that bye week, savored it. Now they're making maybe some believers in the Lone Star State that this team is for real. They're doing it with some much-needed offensive rhythm, Matt, that we focus in on our State Farm double check highlight.
Yeah, they have a nice balance and rhythm going with the both quarterbacks, with Jerod Hurd and Tyron Swoops. Jerod Hurd is a guy, he's more elusive, he's a more dynamic runner, but what they can do is they spread out the offense, and it just makes it difficult for a defense. Here you see down in the red zone, again, Jerod Hurd, when plays break down, he's able to extend those plays. And then your short yardage and your goal line quarterback, Tyron Swoops, 6'4", 6'5", 245 pounds. They've just been more efficient since they've introduced this package coach to their offense. They're a running football team. We saw a lot of that in the first half. I like what they're doing with these two guys.
Yeah, you never like playing two quarterbacks. You know, you always
and
want to be
I don't like
by
running
yourself.
The football because I couldn't run.
I know. You know, I'm a little bit, you know, Coach Snyder at Kansas State has done no one's done a better job at him, you know, under the circumstances up there. And after last week's tough loss, you know, I really expected them to come back this week. And the things that Coach Snyder and Kansas State's football team's known for is the details, doing the little things, always being one step ahead of a situation. And today you're watching the game, and it's a late substitution on the goal line, and Texas scores. You know, you see the kick, the short kick, and nobody feels it. The ball hits the ground. Texas gets the ball. Delay 12 men in the huddle. You know, those little things right there, it seems like they've got their rhythm a little bit as the game has gone on and late in the second quarter. But the key is don't let two losses become one, and that's kind of how they started.
For Texas, Jonathan Gray, already a season-high 89 yards rushing at the break. The highest-scoring team in FBS, number two Baylor, doing what they do best. They are hammering Iowa State right now in rainy Waco. And some thought Miami had what it takes to upset number six Clemson in South Florida today. The Tigers, they had other ideas. The highlights or the lowlights, depending who your team is, next.
Hey, Chip.
Welcome back to the State Farm FS1 College Football Halftime Show.
Former Longhorn Ricky Williams, honored in Austin for his induction into the College Football Hall of Fame. Coach, anything you want to add to that?
Yeah, it's great honor for my man coach. Ricky. There he is, same birthday. It's about May 21st.
Nothing about the Dolphins?
Nothing right now.
Two Saturdays from today, Clemson has fellow unbeaten FSU at home, but the Tigers needed to get by another Florida school today to keep the future meeting of unbeatens alive. Yes, very Miami-esque to stir the pot before kickoff. They maybe should have just kind of kept quiet. Deshaun Watson, Jordan Leggett.
Yeah, you got to obviously walk the walk, and they are not doing it. This is disheartening because obviously it's in Miami. You know, you got a chance to make a statement, beat the top team in your league.
Brad Kaya picked Jadar Johnson. That would set up another Clemson touchdown, second quarter. Tigers up 21-0 at this point. Watson to Scott Watson, 94 rushing yards, 133 passing. Miami just 75 yards of offense so far.
Yeah, it's really two teams going in opposite directions. You know, when you look, Clemson's getting better, and obviously Miami is really struggling.
Okay, Clemson just added another one. How about unbeaten number 21 Houston versus winless Central Florida? Oh, the little strip and rip and run. Brandon Wilson.
That's textbook coach.
That is.
Right
that's
there.
One of those drills you work in practice, and you hope to get one play like that, truly. That's on your highlight tape, and for the next 10 years, the coaches are showing players that play.
Second quarter, but it's Houston down three, not for long. Kenneth Farrow takes it 26 yards out. It's now Cougars up 14. Number 25, Pittsburgh, ranked for the first time since 2009 when who was the head coach?
Well, I don't know. It's
you, man.
But you know what? They better not be reading the newspaper clippings.
That's right. Syracuse getting up there.
This is going to be a ball game up there in the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. It's not an easy place to play. And this if there was such a thing as a rivalry, this game's been going on for a long time. This will go down to the fourth quarter. You know, this will be a physical football team.
Tied at 10s right there. Under a minute to go in the half. Syracuse, third and goal. Eric Dungy, Steve Ishmael. Cuse up. Iowa State at number 2, Baylor. Seth Russell. Play action. Guess who? Corey Coleman. His FBS leading in school record, 17th touchdown.
And it's incredible. I mean, when you give Seth Russell this much time to throw the football, it doesn't matter who's at wide receiver. He's going to pick you apart on defense.
And Russell can run it, too. Need some better cyclone tackling. Still in the first quarter, mind you. Big 12's top rusher, Shaq Linwood, from 17 out.
And this is what makes them so difficult to stop defensively. They will beat you running the football. They will beat you through the air. Shaq Linwood, a big part of that.
Second quarter, Russell, Linwood.
Look at the time, coach.
Yeah, too much. Yeah, obviously, then you start blitzing them, and obviously, then you're one-on-one. You know what I mean? That's the problem with you know, they blitz them, you're one-on-one with Coleman. Now, who's going to cover them?
Baylor seeking their FBS record 6th straight game with 60 or more points today. Why is this offense, rain or shine, good day, bad day, always so productive?
We saw right there, it's their balance, because they can beat you running the football. They don't care how they beat you. If this defense, if a defense is going to sit, play 8-9 in the box, they're going to go over the top to the receivers. They play off and play soft coverage. They'll just hand it off with Shaq Linwood. Seth Russell will get involved in the run game. It's just hard because you can't double team these wide receivers in the secondary, so that's why you see Corey Coleman just going nuts in one-on-one coverage. But like I said, if you play off and you play zone coverage, coach, they're just going to hand the ball off with Shaq Linwood. So you have to pick your poison. It's so difficult to stop.
Yeah, and really, the best chance you have, I mean, they call it the box count. You know, when the quarterback is up there, and it's not that they're changing from pass to pass or from run to run. They're going, it's either going to be a run or pass. The coach calls the play. And then if there's 6 guys in the box where now you have the advantage as far as the number of blockers, obviously they're going to run the ball. If you want to bring a guy in and load up the box, they're going to throw the ball. You got, if I'm defending them, the best chance you have is try to disguise it. I mean, if you can make your quarterback, if you can make Seth Russell indecisive and hand it off when he should be throwing it, now you got a chance to slow these guys down. But they're pretty good at it, and like I say, it's very difficult to disguise and not give up big plays.
We're getting closer and closer to that TCU-Baylor division course. Just a couple weeks away. Texas's Tyrone Soups, the pair of short touchdown runs. The Longhorns thought they were in control, but a late K-State touchdown has it a 10-point game. More highlights and tragedy in Stillwater when we return.
Welcome back to the State Farm FS1 College Football Halftime Show.
Our full day of college football across the Fox networks continues later today. Kansas battling 14th-ranked Oklahoma State here on FS1. Wisconsin, Illinois on the Big Ten Network. And tonight, a Pac-12 showdown on Fox. Third-ranked Utah taking on a USC team looking to get their season back on track. Tragedy this morning as thousands celebrated homecoming at Oklahoma State. A car rammed into the crowd during the homecoming parade. A police update just moments ago in Stillwater telling us that 3 people have now been killed and 27 hospitalized. Certainly a pall in Stillwater ahead of the game as we get set for unbeaten Oklahoma State in action versus Kansas. It's going to be a lot to overcome that news, and it's going to be a lot for them to keep their focus on the field and to maintain their unbeaten record. Are we kind of believers right now in Oklahoma State, or they fit another role for you, Coach?
Well, Mike Gundy and his staff, I mean, they're doing a great job. I mean, let me start off by saying that. But I look at them more as spoilers. I think, you know, they have the right schedule. They got Baylor, TCU, and Oklahoma all in Stillwater, all at home. So that's a positive. They got the defense to be a championship team. And the quarterback and receivers is kind of the strength. The thing that is missing that bothers me, and it's a big bother, is the offensive line is inexperienced, and it's running back by committee. You know, J.W. Walsh, the backup quarterback, Matt, you know, mm-hmm. they bring in, do some wildcat with him, some short yardage. You know, he might be the best runner of the team. And I think to win a championship, yes, it's defense, but you have to be able to run the football against these good teams to win games in the end, and I don't believe they can do it.
That one coming up later today on FS1. Over on Fox, USC at 3-3. Nearly a touchdown favorite at home today over number 3, Utah. That one live on Fox from the Coliseum. Where, though, does Utah, and you would think they would have the edge all over the place, right, being their unbeaten number 3, but where do they have the edge today with this matchup?
They have a decisive advantage up front on both lines. Offensive line with the running game with Devontae Booker and even Travis Wilson having an impact. I think they can make their hay against a weak front four in USC's defense. And then on the flip side, Utah's defensive line led by Hunter Dimick, they get after the quarterback. They collapse the pocket. When Cody Kessler's at his best, it's when he has time, when he's able to sit back there and pick apart a defense. Utah can collapse that pocket, force him off his mark, because he has thrown some interception the last couple weeks. I think that's where they make their hay. And also special teams. Uncharacteristic like last week, they have to be better on special teams for Utah. But I like them. They're just a better football team now.
And don't forget that plus 12 of turnover margin. Utah, one of the best in the nation of not giving you the football.
And USC, they have the speed. They have the talent, obviously. And they can score a lot of points. But I think Utah, with their size and their physicality up front, wins this football.
Another opportunity for Devontae Booker to add to his Heisman hype. The guy deserves it. Yep. That's for sure. Swoops and Texas on the verge of their third win of the campaign. But Kansas State making it close late. Second half kick coming up next.
FS1 College Football is presented by Geico. And enough rain to do some slip and slide. It is pouring. Has been all day. Continues to rain through halftime and into this second half. Texas in front of K-State 16-6. And we welcome you back inside where it's perfectly dry. Sorry, Chris Button, downstairs. Joe Davis, Brady Quinn. Texas 2 weeks ago in the win against Oklahoma ran it 58 of the 70 plays. We thought, whoa, that's extreme. But then the first half here, 40 plays, 36 runs.
Yeah, I think this is their blueprint. This is their identity. This is how they know how to win. When you're talking about the running game, you really should credit the offensive line up front. Left tackle Connor Williams, left guard Cedric Flowers, Taylor Doyle at center, Patrick Vahe at right guard, and Kent Perkins. Kent Perkins at that right tackle position. They've had three different starters throughout the course of this year. Tristan Nicholson was in, Marcus Hutchins. Now they've got an offensive line that they feel good about. Coming out of the bye week, they feel solidified. And oh, by the way, the wide receivers too, doing a nice job blocking downfield. But the key stat, because of the running game, is look at both teams handling the rain, no turnovers. That's always a key anytime you have inclement weather like we're seeing today here in Austin.
And the one, obviously, semi-turnover came in special teams. Texas chipped it downfield and fell on it. Stat comparison is presented by the Lincoln Motor Company. Ready to begin the second half. Kansas State has won 6 of 7 in this series over the last few years, including a shutout win in Manhattan last year. But down by 10 as we get ready to start the second half. Texas trying to build off that momentum with a win against Oklahoma. Kansas State trying to avoid its first 0-4 start to Big 12 play since 2001. DeJay Johnson, dangerous return man, bringing it back. Across the 25, that's where Texas begins the second half. And Chris Budden talked to their head coach, Charlie Strong.
Team that he's seeing out here today. He said you can't expect them to run the football again in this second half. He said they just can't grip the ball in this kind of rain, Joe.
All right, Chris, and I missed the front end of that. We apologize for the rain getting involved in the microphone and making it hard to hear Chris to begin. Charlie Strong's teams have been so good with the lead. 16-6, they begin the second half with a Johnson sweep. And finally, Kansas State is able to shut it down. Jordan Willis, who's been so disruptive this season for K-State, drops him for a loss of one.
Yeah, and that's basically been the sum of Texas' passing game. These jet sweeps that Gerard Hurd just pushes the ball forward. That's considered a pass. Marcus Johnson there without any gloves on.
Jonathan Gray back to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Will Davis makes the tackle. And a chance for Kansas State to force a three and out to begin this second half.
Which will be huge for the momentum of this game. As you can see, Marcus Johnson without any gloves. We talked to him yesterday and he said, I wasn't quite sure if I was going to use gloves or not. Sometimes they help you in the rain. Sometimes they get a little bit slick. Clearly he's tried to go without them.
Sprint draw. They busted this against Oklahoma, but here Kansas State is ready. Will Davis back-to-back tackles. Gray gets dropped at the line of scrimmage. And Kansas State is forced to three and out to begin the second half.
This is exactly what head coach Bill Snyder preached at halftime, getting a stop, getting the ball back in good territory, and giving Kansas State an opportunity to build off of the momentum they had right before half, driving down for a touchdown.
And so first punt of the day for Michael Dixon. Native of Australia hits one that bounces inside the 40. Down there. The Kansas State's offense, which it looked like perhaps figured something out in the final drive of that first half, touches it for the first time in the second. When you come back. Raincoats getting good work in today. Pouring rain all morning and afternoon.
You'd think Chris Budden would share her umbrella with these young ladies, but apparently she's keeping it all to herself.
Now, apparently umbrellas aren't even allowed into the stadium, so Chris Budden is particularly special that she gets to have one. And Kansas State's offense did nothing over the first quarter and three quarters of that first half, but figured it out on the last drive.
A couple nice designed offensive plays to utilize some mismatches and getting guys like Charles Jones in space and getting the ball to Deontay Burton at times as well in the perimeter.
More than half of their first half yards came on their final drive. Justin Sillman into the game for the first time at running back. Redshirt freshman is their leading rusher. He didn't get a touch during the first. From the 40, Huebner looks to throw. Back shoulder for Cook. That ball extremely wet, misfired. Second down.
Not necessarily the look you'd want to throw that particular route combination against. Texas was playing a too high zone coverage there on the outside. They had three defensive players for the two wide receivers for Kansas State. Joe Huebner tried to fit that ball into a tight window and Cody Cook was not on the same page.
Back-to-back throws to begin the second half, and he had Cook open with a step against John Bonney, but missed him. And after a fairly efficient first half for Huebner, despite the conditions, he misfires on his first two here.
Another well-designed play. Kind of a pick route there for wide receiver Cody Cook, who was wide open. Fortunately, with a wet ball and the rain, maybe a little bit of wind, Joe Huebner not able to connect.
He was 6 of 8 in these conditions during the first half. Third and 10. Texas bringing pressure, picked up, but then it leaked through. Bonney with a sack. They brought one too many.
For number 24, John Bonney's going to be playing the nickelback. He's going to have somewhat, it's not a delayed blitz, but he's coming from depth, so it takes him a while to get there. And a lot of time as a quarterback, you don't see that guy coming because he comes so late.
Flag flies. This will either be roughing or running into the kicker as it is downed at the 27. See what the call is here. If they get the kicking leg, it is usually running into the kicker. If they get the plant leg, that's when you typically see roughing.
As opposed to a rugby style we see in college football so much, where the kicker does not have that protection. Not the same as when he stays within the pocket And once there's contact made, that roughing the kicker call is allowed to be made, as opposed to when they boot outside of the pocket to punt the football.
Yeah, lose protection at that point. And because they're looking to the Kansas State sideline and asking what they want to do, it leads you to assume that it is just running into the kicker. So K-State would have the option of taking the penalty and punting it again, or having Texas take it at the 27.
Not an easy decision in inclement weather, because you then worry about a botched long snap to your punter, him mishandling it.
Running into the kicker. That penalty is declined. First down, Texas.
And that's the safe play in that case. Again, rain's starting to come down pretty hard. We've already seen the effect on the Texas special teams kicking a PAT.
So this Texas offense back to the field. Dominant ground game during that first half. Averaged more than 5 yards per carry. 36 of their 40 plays were runs. Here's how Texas rushing attack breaks down. How funky is this?
That just looks weird to me, how you have two rushing touchdowns but minus 2 yards.
Yeah, obviously a sack in there. Yeah. And in college, sacks count against your rushing totals. Deontay Foreman, his first carry of the second half, goes for 14. Elijah Lee with a tackle, first down.
Well, Texas is running these outside zone plays and they're putting pressure on number 29, Sean Newland. Deontay Foreman was able to get outside, break a tackle, and get the first down.
Penetration this time, Travis Britz shut it down, second and long.
This Kansas State defense has really struggled, giving up a ton of yards this past few weeks. Four straight games, as you see on the screen, but they've allowed 237 to Texas so far, and we're about at the halfway point, so this could be game number 5.
Second down and 12. They roll Hurd out. Steps into a throw, and it's incomplete. That is only the second true pass of the game. He's now 4 for 6. All 4 completions have been sweep plays.
Yeah, and that's not necessarily what I'd like to do as a quarterback, is when you're rolling on the boundary into the short side of the field, you only cut down the amount of space you have to fit a ball in there. And you could see Jarrod Hurd had to throw that ball to the outside because there wasn't much room left for John Burt, number 1, the wide receiver, to be able to come back to the football.
They're down and 12 for Texas. Back-to-back traditional throws. Down the sideline and incomplete. Coverage from Donnie Starks on to Jade Johnson. And again, Kansas State has forced a Texas punt.
We thought Texas coming into this game, because of the weather, would try to throw a little bit shorter passes, spread out the Kansas State defense, and dink and dunk. But clearly not. Last 2 passes thrown more downfield, trying to take some shots and loosen up this Kansas State defense.
Dominique Keith back to return it. K-State fans know that often he'll wear 87 on punt returns, wears 4 here, and tries to get outside. Chris Boyd brings him down. The reason he's able to stay at his normal number is because Caleb Pruitt, who is also number 4, is not playing today.
Correct, I have a life mate.
Is that consequential?
With whom are you communicating?
Jake from Planet State Farm.
Jake from Planet State Farm at 0300 hours. State your identity.
It is Jake from Planet State Farm, home of Discount Double Check.
Describe your apparel, Jake from Planet State Farm.
Khakis.
Khakis. Explain.
A dull earthly garment covering male extremities.
Sounds most appropriate.
Mm-hmm. Save mass quantities, even at 0300 hours. Get to a better state.
Still paying too much for home phone service? Do the math. Magic Jack costs only $35 a year for unlimited local and long distance calling to the US and Canada. And with the mobile app, get unlimited text messaging.
Click or visit Walmart today.
I observe things and remember them very accurately. I think that even the way in which a man shaves in the morning is well worth recording.
Many things have made you a man. Trunk Club will make you a better dressed one.
There's only one way to get a gold PS4. And that is not it. Grab a Quesarito or Volcano Quesarito Big Box for your chance to win a limited edition gold PS4 bundle only at Taco Bell.
Football. In Texas, it's more than just a sport. It's a way of life. It starts as a little boy's dream, from Pop Warner to Friday Night Lights. It culminates here, playing for the University of Texas. Hook 'em horns, hook 'em.
Wonderful tones of our statistician, Barry Allen, bringing us back from break. Kansas State with a football, down 10. Defense has been solid to begin this second half. Now can the offense hold up its end of the bargain? Charles Jones, nice hold off that right side. Anthony Wheeler was there to stop him with Duke Thomas. Second down. Wheeler checks out. Another highly touted true freshman linebacker here, all about Malik Jefferson. The staff really fired up about Wheeler's future as well. Second and six. Jones again. That hole was filled beautifully by Peter Jenkins, their leading tackler and senior leader. Third down.
Peter Jenkins has been exceptional this year. Reason being, he's able to diagnose the play quickly, and as soon as the hole opens, he's there to fill it. Watch Jenkins' eyes. He's able to see Jones break it through the line of scrimmage, and he's there to wrap up. A solid tackler in space, and that's the key versus some of these spread teams.
All right, now only two defenders out here on three receivers. Huebner looking that direction. Burton's left all alone, and he was able to get his hands under it for a first down.
Well, Deontay Burton's been the guy in the Kansas State pass game. He's just going to run underneath into this void left by the Texas secondary. Joe, you said it. There was only two guys out on three wide receivers. They try to rush Peter Jenkins out there to play, but unfortunately, there's still that big hole in the defense.
Burton's been impressive today, man. His wet ball, four opportunities, and he's caught all of them.
Previous play of a completed pass is under further review.
Maybe.
Well, I guess the officials can't believe he caught it either.
Yeah.
So they're going to take a look. Look at the ball coming out of Huber's hand. I mean, it's incredibly difficult to get a good grip when it's coming down like this, particularly in the shotgun, too, where you're trying to grab the laces as fast as possible, Joe.
I mean, it looks like it should be juggled, but there's hardly any movement.
No, yeah, and Deontay Burton does a nice job of getting his hands underneath the football. His hands underneath, it looks like he secured the football. You wonder if they're going to be worried about the nose touching the ground.
But it's maybe secured.
Secured at that point.
Deontay Burton from the Little Apple, Manhattan, Kansas. having his best season here in his junior year. You mentioned it, replacing a couple of 1,000 yard receivers last year. Tyler Lockett and Curry Sexton leading the way this season, leading the way today through the air.
And big shoes to fill really for any Kansas State quarterback. We talked about Jesse Ertz getting hurt the first game of the season, Joe Huebner coming in, but anyone coming in the position of Jake Waters was gonna have big shoes to fill. And if this is confirmed, that's a first down Kansas State, you can start to feel the momentum right now shifting.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. First down, Kansas State.
Well, he needs to turn that mic off.
No, quickly, just yell. We'll hear you. So Burton's third down reception extends the drive, first and 10 in midfield. You mentioned the momentum perhaps shifting some. It's begun with the Kansas State defense doing its job early in this half.
In a well-coached team, Bill Snyder, this is exactly what he preached at halftime.
High snap. Huebner pulls it straight ahead. Fooled the crowd and the Texas defense for 7 yards. Dangerous in this weather when you ride that long.
Well, dangerous shotgun snap. Credit Joe Huebner for corralling that ball in. He used every bit of that 6'5 frame to get his arm out there to catch the football. Watch his right hand. Look at that. Oof. Last second was able to pull it away and get upfield.
Under center. Jones downhill, patient running, first down and more. Charles Jones bouncing to the sideline, down to the 25 on a run of 19 yards.
And that's all about vision. For Charles Jones coming back into the lineup this week, he's able to press the hole, he gets running downhill, but watch the jump cut right there. And then he's able to accelerate through the hole and watch number 19, Cody Cook, come in with a block and help Jones get upfield even further.
Helps produce the longest play of the day for Kansas State's offense. Sillman, his first carry. Shy of the 20. Kuna Ford was the first man there. And it's second down. Walk on that now gets replaced by Charles Jones. But Sillman, a guy who came out of the middle of nowhere to really have a good start this season. Redshirted last year. Leading rusher so far this year in his redshirt freshman campaign. Gronkowski helping lead the way for Jones.
And a fast fill by cornerback number 5, Holton Hill. True freshman stepping up. Making a big play, making it 3rd and 6. The red zone's an area where really this Texas defense has struggled a bit, allowing teams scoring 929% of the time. That's a high scoring percentage, allowing 19 touchdowns this season.
On 3rd and 5, pressure got rid of it, incomplete. And Huebner is oh so lucky that it was, because Dylan Haynes had 6 the other way.
And there were really 2 defensive backs for Texas running right with the route. Dylan Haynes comes down for the middle field safety, reading Joe Huebner's eyes the entire time. Holton Hill had pretty tight coverage as well. Both DBs actually got to the football before Kyle Klein was able to.
Jack Cantelli made his first 7 this year. He's missed 2 of his last 3. Right down the middle with this one. And Kansas State back to within a touchdown as Cantelli hits it from 36. Bit of a sloppy one. Surprising how well these teams have taken care of the ball. The lone turnover was a well done kick from Texas. It was recovered off of a bounce, but both offenses taking care of it in a 16-9 game here in Austin. Joe Davis, Brady Quinn, Chris Button. Texas trying to make it back-to-back wins after matching the worst five-game start since 1956. Kansas State trying to avoid its first 0-4 start to Big 12 play since 2001. Trying to come from behind to do it. Texas led this game 16-0. Gonna have a holder for the kick with a wind. Ian Patterson boots it. DeJay Johnson from the 8-yard line. And brought down shy of the 25. How about our Fox 4? Brady, what are we looking at the midway point?
Well, it's not exactly how the AP poll would have it, but Baylor's sitting at number one as opposed to Ohio State. You got Utah. There's Ohio State on the AP poll is the number one team in my poll, number one. And then TCU number four in it. And really, the Fox 4 is just in a different order than the AP poll. When it all comes down to it, it only matters what the College Football Playoff Committee thinks. Their view should be coming out soon, but a big one tonight. Utah, one of the Coliseum to play USC.
Game at 7 Eastern on Fox. Texas trying to get the offense going again. And they hand it off on first down to Chris Warren. His first carry of the game, and in fact his first carry since the Cal game when he went out with an ankle injury.
He's another one of those big backs that Texas loves recruiting. 6'2", 230 pounds. He's got a bit of a burst to him. He's a very talented back. They're extremely excited about the prospect of Chris Warren in the future here at Texas.
Leading the way for Hurd into the short side. Can't turn the corner. He lost a couple. Travis Britz made sure that he couldn't get around the edge. Second down.
Never really understand those quarterback lead plays into the boundary. A guy like Jerod Hurd, so explosive in the open field, give him some more room to run. Love to see that run to the field where maybe he can cut it up or find a running lane or use some of his athleticism.
Almost all ground game. Five of those seven throws have been actually sweeps. Here's Warren into the arms of Elijah Lee. And third down coming up for a Texas offense that was able to move it almost at will during the first half. But Kansas State's defense coming up big in the second so far.
Yeah, in the second half, the difference has been the third down situations they've been put in. Third and 7+, much harder to convert. And credit the Kansas State defense on first and second down.
Texas converted 6 of its first 7. K-State has stopped 3 in a row. Hurd throwing outside, short of the sticks. Wildcats have stopped 4 third downs in a row. Andrew Beck has the reception. It'll be fourth down and 2. Punt team comes out.
And credit the Kansas State coaching staff. Clearly they've made adjustments late in the second quarter, then coming out of halftime, to stymie so far this Texas offense. Getting the ball back now, scoring on 2 drives in a row going back to the first half.
Dixon with a short punt. Look out if you're Kansas State. A lot of white shirts around that ball. What are you doing? Why even be in the area? And it is Kansas State ball.
Right,
so they'll say a legal touching on Texas.
Unbelievable.
So at that point you can pick it up without risking turning it over. Hit Andrew Beck's hand. And then Ryan Mack, smart enough to know the rule, hopped on it. Kansas State back at it. Drove it down for a field goal their last possession to get back to within a touchdown. Charles Jones. Good vision, good patience, 4 yards, second and 6.
We saw
True freshman Devontae Davis come off the corner for Texas. In for John Bonney. Duke Thomas, number 21, then moves to the slot. He's been pretty effective from that position this year. Duke Thomas is another one of these Texas Longhorn leaders on the defensive side of the football. Very experienced, very aggressive. Get up in your face type of guy. Charlie Strong talked about him.
One of the lone veterans in the back end for Texas. Play clock winding down. Just barely got it off. Huebner floats it outside and incomplete. Broken up by one of those freshmen, Devontae Davis. It's remarkable looking up and down this depth chart how much youth there is. More than half of the players listed in the depth chart are either freshmen or sophomores.
And you talk about all the different starting lineups they've had this season. Seven different starters up front on the defensive line, seven different starters in the secondary. But what's the common denominator? A ton of youth.
Now, youth trying to come up with a stop on third down. They bring it underneath. Burton gets drilled. It was Hassan Ridgeway who hit him from behind after Duke Thomas slowed him up. Fourth down.
Well, Texas brings an all-out blitz. Look at all the guys up around the line of scrimmage coming after Joe Huebner. What do you call a screen? Perfect. But credit Hassan Ridgeway, Duke Thomas, being able to get just enough of Burton to bring him down to the ground.
I think it was Luke Hayes that just fanned on the block. No, you were right. It was Hayes that fanned on the block of Duke Thomas. So they've got to punt it away. Johnson retreating. Take it at the 18 and go down. Colby Moore makes the tackle on special teams. World Series begins Tuesday. It's the Mets who last won a World Series in 86. It's the Royals last won it the year before in 1985. Coverage of game one begins 7:30 Eastern on Fox. Extended pregame begins at 7 Eastern on FS1. How about the young arms of the New York Mets? It's the fourth time in the last 5 years that the hardest throwing team has reached the World Series.
It shows you what works. Guys have got those rockets for arms.
Jay Johnson coming in motion, takes the fake. And Kansas State's defense all over Jonathan Gray. Mike Uelmore slowed him up. Travis Britz brought him down.
Donnie Starks, the nickel back in on that action. And if you're Texas right now, you've got to find some other way of moving the football. The Kansas State defense is really starting to figure you out. I'd like to see them spread out the field a bit more. You can still utilize Jerod Hurd, running quarterback draws, but implement some of that quick passing game.
Only 33 yards during this third quarter for Texas after they had over 200 during the first half. Hurd steps up down the sideline. Blew it is wide open. First down Texas on a true pass play of 27 yards.
Well, we've seen variations of this play all throughout the day. They bring Johnson across in motion, but watch, blew it out of the backfield. He catches the Kansas State defense sleeping. And you better believe the play caller, Jay Norvell, has been waiting and holding this one in his back pocket until some point here in the second half.
And used it to hopefully spark this offense if you're a Longhorn fan. Almost double their total yardage for this quarter on that one play. Liked it so much, they'll try a deep ball again. John Burt defended by Morgan Burns. Senior defending the freshman, second and 10.
John Burt, one of the true freshmen here for Texas, had a step, ball's a bit underthrown, and Burns making a nice play to recover, to get in position, and almost come down with the football. Nice play by Morgan Burns.
They'll throw it again. And Burt juggled it and caught it. 6 yards, three consecutive true dropback passes.
Maybe someone's listening to us, but clearly they want to get Jerod Hurd a bit more into rhythm. They're giving us some simple, easy completions on the outside. John Burt being the guy they're trying to work to.
Third down. Empty set. Hurd under pressure. extends the play and throws one that's caught. Burt's got it. Wide open Texas attack, huh?
Well, Jerod Hurts going to be rolling out of the pocket to evade the Kansas State pressure, but look at the maturation process of Jerod Hurts finding John Burt downfield, keeping his eyes upfield. So hard to do sometimes when you've got guys running in your face. Wet rain, weather, wet ball, can't quite grip it very well, but Hurts finding a way to get the conversion and make the play.
And you saw the official throw his hat to signify that John Burt went out of bounds, but he was pushed out, which means that that's not an illegal touching penalty.
And if you're number 29, Sean Newland, there's not much you can do. You see he's forced out. I mean, he's playing about as tight of coverage as you can.
Yeah.
John Burt just makes an incredible play. That thing's like catching a bar of soap, a wet bar of soap when you're talking about these sorts of conditions. It's incredibly hard to catch not only a shotgun pass or a shotgun snap, let alone a pass downfield like that.
John Burt averaging more than 20 yards per catch in his freshman season.
The previous play is under further review to see if the receiver went out on his own.
So they're going to take a look at this to see if he was indeed forced out, which is a reviewable offense.
And once the quarterback leaves the pocket, the defensive back is allowed to make contact like this. He was indeed forced out. His best to come back in.
Well, over the first 19 plays of this half, Brady, 33 yards for Texas. Last three plays, all passes, 53.
Yeah, and John Burt now with a reception every game this season. From Tallahassee, Florida, Lincoln High School.
You know, it's kind of an interesting thing. I think you could make an argument that he was stepping out on his own, then the contact came. It's a little bit of a tricky situation here with the way the contact happened. Let's see what they call.
The rolling on the field is confirmed.
Okay.
First down, Texas.
So it's confirmed, and a first down for the Longhorns.
And that might be a tough bait to overturn, at least in the context of that particular play.
What a great individual effort on that play by John Burt. Texas has it moving again with a first down at the Kansas State 32. Trick play. DeJay Johnson. Running by Geary. Flag down. It's coming back. This one's coming back. Went for 25.
It's going to be on Caleb Blewett.
Judging by that reaction.
Holding. Offense number 95. 10-yard penalty. Play first down.
Well, that would be difficult because if it was 95, that'd be Puna Ford, and yeah. I don't think he was in. But I would assume he got the number wrong. I don't necessarily know if they meant someone on the offensive line. We're going to check it out and take a look. Yeah, right there. They're probably trying to call it on Caleb Blewett.
Yeah.
And that's one of the toughest things with those trick plays and misdirection plays is, as an offensive player, trying to get your hips and your body in line with where you're anticipating that player being and trying to block the defender, and it's near impossible because your back's turned to them.
95 was the number of the player that he held, Travis Britz. Try to get some of it back, and they do. Jonathan Gray, who is nearing 100 yards on the afternoon, now 94 on 16 carries.
I'll be curious if Texas looks to make this four down territory where they're at after the botched PAT snap earlier in the game.
Play action. Hurd retreating. stiff arming and walking out of bounds and just handing Kansas State 4 yards.
Well, that's sometimes what happens with a redshirt freshman. You'd like to see him throw that football away. Right guard Patrick Vahe got beat off the ball, really nowhere for Gerard Hurd to go, but in that particular case, save the sack, save some of the yardage, just throw it away.
So right now, the penalty on the reverse looking like a drive killer. His third quarter winding down. Charlie Strong's team in front by a touchdown in a game that has not been pretty, but he's hoping. Bottom line, lines up a W. FS1 College Football is presented by Geico. We are through at three quarters in Austin. On to the fourth after this. Longhorns had a 16-0 lead early on in this one. K-State has scored 9 in a row. It's a touchdown game as we go to the fourth and we go to Chris Budd.
Well, Joe, I'm not the only one having some audio issues down here in the rain. I've been watching the Kansas State sidelines and the coaches' headsets have been had to be replaced a couple times. Not really holding up in this wet weather. The electronics down here, they just don't do well in the rain. Your headsets sound great, though, in that dry booth.
Oh, we appreciate it. It is.
She's got an umbrella. Don't let her complain.
Hurd with a straight drop on third and long. Down the sideline and too tall. Over the head of John Burt. It's fourth down, and you go back to that penalty late in the third quarter. They ran a sweep that would have made it first down, or a reverse that would have made it first and goal, but had a hold, and it kills the drive.
That play mixed with Gerard Hurd effectively taking a sack by not throwing the football away. Maybe it saves you some yards. Maybe that changes the type of play goal you utilize on this particular third down.
Dominique Keith back to return Michael Dixon's punt. And you know, Texas fans, when you combine this weather with Dixon's history of having dropped that ball against Oklahoma State, have their nightmares come alive again. But what an incredible play by Dixon. Play of the game by the freshman from Australia. He turns a disaster into a 33-yard punt.
What a heads-up play by Dixon. I mean, we saw the woes and what could possibly happen with that epic loss for Michigan and Ann Arbor, the punter mishandling it. But this time, Dixon has the wherewithal to get the football, turn around and kick it. Let's see if Kansas State can respond.
Well, kicking game has been an adventure for Texas this year. Of course, Roses missed extra point against Cal in the final minutes after the long Hurd touchdown run got him to within one. This is against OK State. A drop snap from Dixon, then a 10-yard punt led to the game-winning field goal. Earlier today, they had the high snap on the extra point. And just a moment ago, near disaster turned into a huge play by Dixon.
The biggest difference is Kansas State didn't really have a rush on. They just had a couple of defenders that saw the mishandled snap and tried to run after it. If that was a punt rush, that could have been disastrous.
Yeah. So backed into their own end. Charles Jones, blockers in front. And Jones with close to a first down. Just one last thing, putting a cap on that punt. Barry Allen, our stats guy, tells us that it was a 33-yard punt, but it shifted the field 61 yards from if he hadn't gotten it off.
The Kansas State offense seems okay and have to go the distance of the field almost. Dolan Reisner, Boston Stuyvesant did a nice job of pulling out around to allow Charles Jones to get the end.
Play clock down to 5. He's under center. And they'll get the first down.
You know, you wonder at some point if the missed PAT for Texas will come back to bite them, or the decision to go for 2 early in the game in the first half by head coach Bill Snyder, which they weren't able to get, will come back to bite Kansas State. We'll see as this fourth quarter ensues.
Jones. Haynes one-on-one. Can't get him with an arm tackle. He needed help and got plenty of it from Shyrod Davis. 3 yards, second and seven.
Shyrod Davis has incredible athleticism running to the football. He's going to be pinned inside, and he's just going to keep fighting and follow the play. Able to finally wrestle down Charles Jones. Shyrod Davis is more of a pass rush specialist, but does a tremendous job too and not giving up on those running plays as well.
Huebner takes off. Jones blocks Jenkins, allowing Huebner to get a first down. Ran into his own man. Still got a first down.
The biggest key to running an effective quarterback draw is having patience. A lot of times as a quarterback, you get so excited to actually run because the play is designed for you that you take off before the blocking is able to set itself up. Huebner with tremendous patience and a good job being able to see the hole and get downfield.
Fumbled snap. Huebner's on it.
People think sometimes that when you have a rainy game that it's easier to be under center as opposed to being in shotgun. The problem is the center's butt's wet, your hands are wet, you're combining the two with a wet ball. Just a lot of moisture out there. When you're in shotgun, you're able to dry your hands off. You're not having to put your hands on the butt of the center. Sometimes it's actually easier in the rain handling the football.
Lost two, second and 12, inside of 12 minutes. High snap this time. Takes his eyes down. Jenkins runs him down.
Kansas State was effective with a quarterback draw a couple plays ago. They try to come back with it. Peter Jenkins is not fooled. As soon as that hole opens up for Joe Huebner, it's Jenkins with the speed to be able to track him down for the backside.
Third and 20, Huebner into traffic and incomplete. Threw it up for grabs. Five burnt orange shirts down there. Fourth down.
Credit big number 98, Hassan Ridgeway. We talked about him having the ability to penetrate the pocket. Texas gives a little bit of a funky look up front, and Ridgeway just finds his way back into Huebner's lap.
Really short punt and taken by Duke Thomas at midfield. Texas will have it with 10 and a half to go. Both teams all three timeouts. One touchdown game. You know you're going to see a heavy dose of that Texas run game. You come back. Back here in Austin, early on in the fourth quarter. Rain's been falling all day if you're just joining us. And they're honoring Bevo 14, who passed away a few weeks ago. The search for Bevo 15 is on until they find the right Bevo. They'll honor the 14th like that. The Texas offense back to the field. K-State's defense has started to shut things down in this second half. Texas had a 16-0 lead at one point. DeJay Johnson takes it. Bounces backwards. Somehow turns the corner and gets 4 or 5 yards.
And that's really just the speed of DeJay Johnson being able to get to the edge. Donnie Starks, number 10, their nickelback, had leverage, but misjudged the speed of Johnson to get to the outside where he's still able to make a positive gain. And that's the key for this Kansas State defense, is having better production stopping Texas on first and second down.
Hurd keeps it. Look at Duke Shelley. True freshman corner flew up and clipped him down for a loss. It's third and eight.
a four-star recruit out of Tucker, Georgia. Gerard Hurd thinks he's got all sorts of room to run, but Duke Shelly comes like a missile out of the secondary to get the tackle. It's a big-time play for the freshman.
Second straight start for him with Denzel McDaniel out. This banged-up secondary hasn't been exposed today because of the weather. They'll get attacked here, you would assume, on third and eight.
Watch out for the quarterback draw. That's been effective in this formation earlier in the game.
A lot of room on that second level. They roll him out. Hurd throws on the move. Completed to Johnson, but for a gain of just three. Donnie starts the tackle, and it's fourth down.
It was interesting. Number 35, Will Davis, was on Johnson earlier, then kind of came off of him to force Hurd to make the throw. Fortunately, Starks was there to come up, make the tackle, and force Texas to punt. Now Kansas State has to try to swing this momentum to their favor.
Remember the last snap from Jack Holbrook went over the head of Michael Dixon. This one's right on the money. Another good one. Chris Boyd threw it back, but it took a Kansas State bounce into the end zone. Very close to being as perfect as you can do it. 55 yards, but into the end zone and the ball at the 24. K-State down a touchdown. FS1 College Football is presented by GEICO. We're back to Austin after this.
The Columbus Kid.
Texas has not scored since taking that 16-0 lead. Kansas State within a touchdown. 8:46 to go, and they begin the drive at the 20. Charles Jones, a career high today. Jones moving over 80 yards. How does Kansas State put together a game-tying drive here?
You know, I'm curious to see at some point if they use some of those double moves on the outside. Kansas State has been effective with that historically. They missed some opportunities the past couple weeks downfield, taking some shots. Curious to see when they're going to pull that out of their bag of tricks.
On second and short, Jones slips through, spins his way free. Charles Jones, a first down across the 40. Dylan Haynes with the tackle after 15 yards.
We talked about Charles Jones' ability after contact to keep his legs moving. Does a nice job with the spin move to get away from Jason Hall. Dylan Haynes able to wrestle him down. Safeties for Texas have struggled a bit at times making tackles. Some people think maybe P.J. Locke, true freshman, or Deshaun Elliott, now that he's healthy, maybe would be two better guys to go with on the back end.
Jones again, 100 yards on the day and more. Jason Hall pushes him out of bounds inside the 40 after 21 more for the junior from Louisiana.
Credit the left side of this offensive line, in particular left tackle Cody Whitehair. He's on the Outland watch list, the Lombardi watch list. He's one of the leaders on this offensive line for K-State. Good size, good athleticism. 34 straight starts for Whitehair.
Justin Sillman giving Jones a break. Sillman going backwards, thrown down by Anthony Wheeler.
Well, number 68, Luke Hayes, gets blown into the backfield by number 93, Paul Boyette. That's really what created this disruption and allowed Wheeler to get into the backfield along with Peter Jenkins.
One of those many freshmen contributing on this Texas defense. Second and 15 inside of 7 minutes. Play clock inside of five. Didn't get it off. Looks like they got a timeout.
Timeout. Kansas State, first charge timeout of the half.
But in a game like this, not how you want to use one of those three timeouts. It'll be second down and 15 for K-State when we come back. FS1 College Football is presented by GEICO. Fourth quarter. Nice moves. 7-point game. Kansas State with a football. 6:38 left on the move, but after the loss on first down, second and 15.
Yeah, you got to wonder, they went for a fourth down earlier in this game, but Bill Snyder's pretty conservative. You wonder if this is four down territory with them with 6:38 left in the game.
Huebner popped. Short gained. And it's third down and 13. Huebner a little bit slow getting up. Bump continues to whine. He was hurt on the first play of the game today on a hit up high. Clearly came back in. This appears to be a lower body injury. There's the guy that would take over, Cody Cook. Huebner's got to come out.
Zach Davidson, the other quarterback who's here with Kansas State today, a redshirt freshman. He's on the trip, but they didn't plan on playing him. Cody Cook is going to come in. They need him most. We talked about his performance versus Oklahoma State in relief of Huebner. Pretty heroic. Two touchdown passes, one touchdown run, and three quarters of play. But Oklahoma, he struggled just like Huebner did. And these sorts of adverse conditions, curious to see what Daniel Dimmel decides to dial up for Cody Cook.
Chris Button told us a moment ago during the break that it is right now raining as hard as it's rained all day. Perfect spot to have to step into. Now, listen to the crowd he's got to deal with. Cook scrambles and throws it away. Hassan Ridgeway, the big man, came barreling up the middle and forced the throwaway.
And what about this? Look at the big guys up front. Hassan Ridgeway coming from the interior, splitting through the double team of Cody Whitehair and Boston Syverson. Cody Cook, by the way, very wise play. He's coming in cold to come in and throw a pass. Not an easy task to handle.
And so we're still 5:56. They'll punt it. And the line drive goes into the end zone. So Texas will have it at the 20. They only gain 19 yards net on that punt. Texas offense comes back out trying to run some clock. Kansas and OK State follows us. And our thoughts are with those in Stillwater. If you've not heard by this point, there was a car that crashed into the homecoming parade in Stillwater today. Three people confirmed dead, last reported. So playing with heavy hearts in a homecoming game when we finish.
Thoughts and prayers to those affected in Stillwater.
Trout Hurd in this offense back at it from the 20. Jonathan Gray sticks his nose down, shut down. Will Davis has played a good game at his linebacker spot. And this has really been what it's looked like for much of this second half against the K-State defense.
Yeah. Number 29, Sean Newland struggled at times, but that last play, he came up, took on a double team, helped freed up Will Davis to make a play. That's what this K-State defense preaches. Unselfishness, playing for one another.
Gray again, this time a hole. Submarine by Starks. Just shy of the first down, third and a long one or a short two as we wind down near 5 minutes. 18-wheeler coming in, first time in this second half.
You know exactly what to expect. The downhill, smash mouth, running game. It's so physical. The crowd loves it, players love it. Jay Norvell ran it in Oklahoma with Blake Bell.
K-State having a hard time getting lined up. They're going to throw out of it. Swoops for Beck. Incomplete. He was wide open, and Swoops threw it behind him. Gift wrapped for Kansas State. Fourth down.
But Tyrone Swoops has struggled with accuracy throughout his career. That's why Jerod Hurd is in the game. And sometimes it's tough to hit those so wide open wide receivers, and it's not always easy throwing to a tight end either. It's a little harder for them to adjust to the football, but just unfortunate. It was a great play diagrammed up. Take advantage of what they've utilized so far with the 18-wheeler package.
Dixon, a good punt. Heath lets it bounce, and it cost him 10 or 15 yards. Rolls down to the 20. 50-yard punt for Michael Dixon, who's been key for Texas in this second half. And 4:22 to go. A 7-point game. While we've got a moment, check in with Jenny Taft for a game break.
Joe, thanks. Northwestern visiting Nebraska. The Wildcats trying to break a 2-game losing skid. Clayton Thorson finds Dan Vitale 37 yards for the touchdown. The Wildcats take a 27-22 lead in the fourth quarter. Joe Brady, back to you.
All right, Jenny, so a good one there, a good one here. And it's Cody Cook in at quarterback with Huebner going out with a lower body injury on the previous possession. Jones, Jenkins got it. Second down.
Well, this Texas defense has really answered the bell. Since playing Oklahoma 2 weeks ago, they've been more aggressive. They played with more confidence and more energy. You see Joe Huebner coming back into the game, a good sign for Kansas State.
As it winds inside of 4 minutes, this has got to be the drive if you're K-State. Huebner on a bum leg, still steps into the throw and completes it for a first down. First catch of the day for Andre Davis, senior out of Baltimore, moves the chains to the 31.
And right now, Texas is playing with two true freshmen on the outside. We talked about how Kansas State likes to utilize these double moves. That was a nice little short hitch route to Andre Davis right in front of him. We'll see if they come back with a double move off of that.
Look in that direction. Huebner all day to throw. And will sling it out of bounds. Second down and 10.
Well, Joe Huebner is going to hate himself on film tomorrow after the game, because he had an opportunity just to check it down to Charles Jones right in front of him. I don't know if the offensive line was blocking his view, but Charles Jones releases through after he checks his protection. And Huebner has all day. He's sitting right out in front of him.
3:08 left, two timeouts for Kansas State. Against a four-man rush, under pressure, floats it up and picked off. Dylan Haynes, his seventh career interception.
And Dylan Haynes is going to receive all the credit for this. Right here, number 14, but credit number 93, Paul Boyette, right here. Look at him. He forces Joe Huebner to throw that football before his feet were set, before he was ready. The Texas defensive front has been penetrating all day long, making Joe Huebner uncomfortable in the pocket. As you see, he couldn't get his shoulders and his body squared back around to the throw. That's going to make a quarterback inaccurate 9 times out of 10.
So 3:02 left. And because Huebner and the offense had to use a timeout with a play clock running down a few minutes ago, two timeouts remaining. Swoops comes in to run quarterback. Behind Alex De La Torre, Tyrone Swoops stays on his feet. First down inside the 40.
And Swoops coming back in the game and totally redeeming himself. Talked about his physical nature and his size. And again, credit that right side of the offensive line for Texas. Cedric Flowers, big number 96, pulled around 2 to lead the way.
2:40 Clock running. No true tailback in the game right now. Lined up next to Swoops is the fullback, De La Torre. Swoops again. Into the clear. Tyrone Swoops inside the 15. 13 yards and then 26 yards. Texas trying to put it away on the shoulders of Swoops.
We talked about De La Torre and Beck, but watch big number 66 come around and help create the hole for Tyrone Swoops. A little misdirection. Call this a counter play. Excuse me, that's De La Torre coming around, but Flowers as well to help create that hole for Swoops.
Six, four, 245 rumbling his way down to the 10-yard line. First down and goal for Texas. Swoops again. He's got room. Steps out of a tackle. Tyrone Swoops. Third touchdown of the day.
Texas comes back with essentially the same exact play. Morgan Burns blitzes off the edge. He can't get there. Sean Newland, he can't bring down Tyrone Swoops. And sure, Michael Moore had a last chance. And John Burt threw a block to help him get in the end zone. What redemption for Tyrone Swoops after starting versus Notre Dame this season, then getting benched. But he's played in every single game this season, has really provided a spark and helped mentor Jerod Hurd.
The chant is Swoops. There it is. Rose barely hooks that one inside the upright. A junior on a tiny white right Texas. Three plays on the drive. They were all Swoops runs. 52 yards total. Capped off by the 10-yard touchdown run. He's got all three Texas scores today.
Backup role in this 18-wheeler package.
Morgan Burns blocking the back. Flags flying all over the place. Chopped down at the 35. Mentioned it, you feel great for Swoops, not just coming back from that ball he threw behind his intended receiver on third down that forced the punt, but in the bigger picture, him losing his job, coming back and playing such a big role.
And Coach Strong talked about him still continuing to mentor Jerod Hurd and being a leader on this team. Strength coach in the weight room talked about his work ethic, how it never failed. He leads the guys off the field as well and encouraging them in the weight room. A nice story to see a guy be able to bounce back and still understand his importance to this team. That's what football is all about.
Minute 35, two timeouts. K-State hoping for a couple of miracles. This ball is incomplete. Haynes nearly had his second interception of the day. Former walk-on Dylan Haynes moved into the starting role early on last year, and he's been a ball hawk. Seven interceptions in his year plus in that starting job at safety. Minute and a half left, second down and 10. Huebner hits the crosser. Andre Davis gets game tackled. Thomas and Hill combined, third down.
When you're able to get pressure with your front four like Texas has today, it allows you to play more coverage, more zone, where everyone's watching the eyes of the quarterback, Joe Huebner, and they're breaking up to make tackles on the wide receivers. It's hard to be able to throw the ball downfield.
Huebner throws the corner out and hits Heath. These Kansas State receivers have done a good job holding on to the ball in the rain today.
Yeah, not easy this particular case. They run a high low on Holton Hill, freshman cornerback on the outside. You see Heath run above him. There's Burton below him. Huebner makes the right choice, throws a nice football and allows Heath to get out of bounds and get the first down.
The fact that Burton wasn't ready for the snap played to their benefit. Corner didn't move. Pressure. Huebner goes down. Bryce Cottrell credit for the sack. Fourth of the day for the Texas defense.
Talked about their effectiveness up front. Look at the speed off the edge. Nice job with Cottrell's hands being able to chop down Matt Kleinsorge's hands. That's usually the effectiveness anytime you're a big defensive end or defensive tackle. And it'll chop those arms down and get back to the quarterback.
But our Dr. Pepper, one of a kind plays of the game. They came in these last few minutes. It was a one touchdown game when Dylan Haynes intercepted Joe Huebner. And then three plays, three runs for Tyrone Swoops, capping it off with a 10-yard touchdown run. Those are the one-of-a-kind Dr. Pepper plays of the game.
I thought it was going to be Michael Dixon. You loved that earlier in the game.
It was big. I mean, that was huge. He didn't get that punt off. It's a one-touchdown game, and Kansas State has the ball at the Texas 30.
You know me. I just don't like talking about special
you
teams
don't.
All the time.
No. If there was ever going to be a special teams play that you'd be cool talking about, would have been that one, right?
Maybe a field goal to win the game.
Okay. You're forced to. Not really no choice then. Charlie Strong, 43 seconds away from getting his second consecutive win.
It was fun to watch his players celebrate with him a couple weeks ago versus Oklahoma. It's seldom you see players carry a coach off the field like that. I guess I should say pick him up and throw him around like that. These players truly love Charlie Strong and the culture that he's built here in Austin.
Huebner gutting it out, playing with that sore leg, and heaves this one out of bounds. Third down. You mentioned that reaction after the win a couple of weeks ago. And to anybody that's bought into that narrative that Charlie Strong has lost the locker room, that's all you need to see to prove that wrong.
Not even close. Talking to these players, they look at this man as a father figure. And sometimes these players are coming from, you know, backgrounds where they need that sort of guidance and that sort of culture. And Charlie Strong has provided that to the players here at Texas. He's done a tremendous job academically as well. One of the highest GPAs they've had here for quite some time, cumulative amongst the players on this team.
Third down and 22. Rush only three and still get to Huebner, forcing a fumble that it appears is recovered by Texas. And did Kansas State get on it? Somehow Huebner did. But it's fourth down and that clock running.
Timeout, Kansas State.
And Texas is only rushing three guys. And number 46, Malik Jefferson, the middle linebacker, he's acting like he's rushing, but really he's really sitting there as a spy waiting for Huebner to leave the pocket. You got to ask more of your offensive line and even your running back, Charles Jones. You get six on three. There should be double teams all across the board.
Derek Roberson with the pressure there. Part of this very deep defensive line for Texas. Team that'll move to 3-4 on the season. 2-2 in Big 12 play.
And really, Texas might have been closer than we thought to being a team that could strap together a couple wins, one in particular versus a top 20 team in Oklahoma just a couple weeks ago. Played such a daunting schedule. Five of their six first opponents were ranked in the top 25. Toughest schedule out there in college football. Now they've got the opportunity to string together some wins and become bowl eligible.
They need to go 3-2 down the stretch in order to do that. Bill Snyder, meanwhile, sees his team begin Big 12 play 0-4 for the first time since 2001. Huebner heaving one, broken up. Devontae Davis, Dylan Haynes came together to knock it away. And Now Texas can take a knee and run this out.
Well, all Joe Huebner can really do is try to take a shot downfield to Andre Davis in the soft spot of that two-deep zone coverage. Davis does a nice job retreating, and Dylan Haynes had a heck of a game. Talked about him being a former walk-on. Really stepped up his play the past couple games versus Oklahoma and now Kansas State today.
He's from a great Texas family. His dad, John, played defensive tackle here in the early 80s. Had a brother play receiver. His mom, his grandpa, his great uncle, all were on the track team at Texas at one point. Tyrone Swoops was a big part of the equation today, scoring all three touchdowns for the Longhorns. Will come on the victory formation. Appropriately so today. On a day where the eyes of Texas were on Tyrone Swoops and Charlie Strong as the Longhorns get their second consecutive win after that 1-4 start. Charlie Strong and a guy that he admires, and who doesn't? Bill Snyder. Last words at midfield. 23-9, the final score. Texas over K-State. Right now, we send it to Rob Stone in Los Angeles.
All right, Joe, with our Chris Budden.
Coach, you mentioned after the OU game, you said, I like this team that I saw out there today. They're a good team. That same confident team came out today. What's been the difference, and what have you seen from your team in these last 2 weeks?
Well, what you said, it's all about confidence, and you have to continue to build on it. You look at the big win at OU, and now we bounce back today in these conditions, and they played well, and we were played well enough to go win the football game, and we just played as a team.
Tyrone Swoops, the way that he played today, could have gone a different direction when you take away a guy's starting role, and he came out today, punched in three touchdowns. What does that say about his character?
Oh, Tyrone's an unbelievable young man, and you're right. He gave up the starting position and actually heard when played well, and then Tyrone has bounced back, and he has a role, and we provided him a role on the team. That's why he's playing so well.
Defense struggled early in the season. I know it's against some of the top teams in the country, but the way that they stopped them today, what did they do that made them so efficient?
Well, just you have to make it one-dimensional, and we knew they had to run the ball, but then the quarterback made some throws, but just playing together, just always running to the football, just being around the ball.
Appreciate the time. Go in. Go get dry.
All right.
Thanks, Coach.
Ready to go, Charlie.